I love that intro.
That
this is what you call in my country amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to LCD. Oh, it is LCD tonight. Okay, good.
Oh,
I was
yeah.
thinking we don't have LCD, but we do. We have.
I have Crosby's
what do we
here.
Have tonight? We have.
Crystal.
No.
Oh, my name. I'm Lindsay. Crystal.
And David. That's the LCD, ladies and gentlemen.
Kiss me.
All right, so don't read that. We got a lot to go over. This podcast will probably be called A Trip Through Lindsay's Mind.
What?
I'm going to take everyone on a trip through Lindsay's mind. I'm going to tell them what she thinks about, because she's a little bit crazy.
It's going to be a very short
trip. She's crazy brain. But I think we want to go on with something else first. Is there anything you want to go over first, Lindsay? Shoot through things really? Because also, this could be called A Date with David and Lindsay. But Crystal, too. We're going to go on a date.
I'm just chaperoning.
Crystal is our chaperone.
Ooh, Crystal chaperone.
Well, I have a list of questions, but I think I'm just going to pepper our performance with them.
Well, I want it to be like we're on a date. Like, bottles clinking. Wait, is there a clink, clink, clink? Like, clink.
I would need two bottles of beer for that.
Whatever.
get Lindsay another bottle of beer.
Totally. I do it for my craft.
Because we were sitting at... Give me that, stupid! Give it to me!
Okay. So, I just went back to third grade. Lindsay
know,
took
Lindsay.
David's paper away.
I'm going to touch
vagina. And she's holding it above his head.
Vagina!
So gross.
Okay. See, that's what I have to do is I threaten to touch another vagina and she stops doing whatever I want.
But as chaperone, I think I have to stop you from touching
another
vagina.
Yeah, no kidding!
I think that's off limits. There's two areas. I'll highlight them with a marker right there.
Right. She's like a plastic surgeon.
Now I feel unsafe on the podcast that I can't even have my notes on the table. Lindsay will abscond with them.
Well, you know what? If you didn't react so much, like when you gave me the human bra, if I liked the human bra, you wouldn't like it.
But you love the human bra. There's nothing you love more than being human
bra. I do
bra
love
fight.
The human bra. That's
ladies
why I react so much so you continue to do it.
Ooh. Ladies and gentlemen, there is nothing better. There's no better support for a lady than the human bra.
I agree, but you actually need, my friends and I figured this out when we were like 14 or something. You need two guys, one on each side, because if you have one guy behind you, that's going to impede your motion. And you won't be able to like do things like running or walking properly. You have two guys, one on each side, as long as they, you know, do the right level of support.
Oh my!
I know, but I'm afraid that they're
going
to do one up, one down, one up, one down, one up, one down.
We were 14. We weren't sluts. We just thought about it, okay?
Look, proper back support does not make you a slut.
Stop looking at my notes.
I'm looking at something else.
No, because we were sitting at dinner tonight, and I realized I had no idea what Lindsay's favorite color was. And we've been friends for 46 or 47
it's
years.
It's a bad friend.
Yeah, it's green. I found out it's green it's with green. A little
I
bit of gray.
Crystal. Lindsay and I are better friends than you guys.
Wait, what's your favorite color?
Purple. Yeah, purple.
That's his favorite color, too.
Well,
she's
like
her
dark
color, too.
Dark shade of purple, like the royal purple.
I like royal purple, yeah.
Royal purple is lame. You guys are lame.
No, I have another
right, favorite song,
color.
Crystal.
Wait, I have another favorite color.
Mint green. Crystal, what's your favorite song?
I don't have a favorite.
All right, think about that. We'll get back to you. David, what's your favorite song?
My favorite song of all time that always moves me is Sebastian by Sex Gang Children.
Wow.
That's a beautiful, amazing
song. I like Babushka
song.
By Kate Bush.
You do not? That's your favorite song of all time?
Because oh, yes.
I don't want to touch your vagina.
I think my all-time favorite song is Life on Mars by David Bowie. Can we hear it?
Wait, sing it?
Is there sing Life it. On Mars?
All I know by him is Baby's on Fire.
David Bowie does not sing
he
that.
Did it. Well, he didn't sing it. Brian Eno does, but they did it together.
So why would
you
know
David Bowie songs?
I do know, but I can't think. Oh, fame, 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 fame.
What about Modern Love? Modern Love gets
oh, God,
me
I hate
to
that
the
shit.
Church.
He should have been shot. Someone should have shot him instead of John Lennon right before he did those albums.
That's horrible. That's not
that
true.
Is that bad? Is
yeah,
that bad?
That's
okay,
bad
sorry,
and fucked right. up.
Let's go on to the next. What's your favorite song, Crystal?
I still
come
have
on,
no
Babushka
no
by
song.
Kate Bush. It's
name
still
like
open.
A couple. Name a couple of your favorite songs.
I really can't. I've got no
damn.
Idea.
All right, what's your next there's question? We're on a date.
What's your favorite movie? We're on a date, the three
what's
of us.
What's your favorite movie? I can name Lindsay's. Lindsay's three top favorite. Lindsay, could you think of a more cliched favorite movie? Citizen Kane is her favorite movie of all time. But then she also loves, get this,
I'm
Gone
a very
with
wholesome
the Wind
person.
And Casablanca. Those are her
I
favorite
hate
films.
I Casablanca.
I thought that was one of your favorite films.
No, I said I hated it.
Oh, then, well, Gone with the Wind and something else. What was the other one?
I like Grand Illusion.
No, there was another one that you said, and I gave you shit for it because it was totally douchey.
I like An American in Paris.
No, there was another one. But y'all, she loves also loves Singing in the Rain. That's one of her favorite songs too. I mean, wait, favorite
movies. Yeah,
singing songs and movies. What is your favorite movie?
I don't know. One of my favorite movies is 10 Things I Hate About You.
What? Really? I've never seen it.
I like teen movies.
Who's it? I love teen movies.
You know what is Julia kind of hot in that movie? Remember Heath when Ledger. They're doing paintball or whatever? And yeah. They make out in the hay? That was one of the all-time greatest first kiss
That's in
a movie.
That's in 10 Things I Hate About You?
Yeah, I had to rewind that like 15 times, no joke.
Did you get off on it?
I got Ladywood, yeah.
Wait, do you like Mean Girls, Crystal?
Mean Girls was all right. I only saw it once. It wasn't.
I've seen like 15 times, and there's no part of it. You know how there's some movies that are your favorite movies, but some parts get boring and you want to fast forward?
Yeah.
There's no part of that movie that is fast forward.
Which, have you seen 10 Things I Hate About You?
No, I want to see it
it's
now.
It's good. It's witty. I have it on DVD and VHS if you would like
I
to.
I see
Panning
it.
Of the Shrug High School style.
Yeah.
Ooh, really?
It's really
and
well done.
She's Kate or whatever. Mm-hmm. You know what? One of my favorite movies, Crystal and Peter turned me on to, it's called Come Out of the Closet by what's his name?
Out of the Closet.
Out of the Closet.
R. Kelly.
By R. Kelly.
R. Kelly.
It's amazing.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
Really he's funny. A midget. And oh my God. Like it's
I know.
Really
it's
good,
just
yeah.
stream of consciousness. It's just yeah. like he's describing stuff in the room.
But then they showed me not only that, they showed me his director's cut where he's telling about like, oh my God, I thought like what could be the craziest thing I could do? Like, oh my God, a midget yeah. come out of the closet. And I thought like, whoa, that's like just like life, but it's also crazy too. And it's like,
it's
yeah,
great
that's
he's like,
like
oh,
life.
You know,
exactly.
No one ever thought that, you know, I put that in there because that was going to surprise everyone and yeah. no one would ever think there was a midget in there and we're all like we so knew there was a midget in there like you know what's
Idiotic.
Gonna happen he's
yeah.
so predictable but he thinks that
Wait,
it's
how
not
do you know there's
yeah
a midget
he thinks
there.
He's Alfred freaking Hitchcock
how do you know
thinks.
There's a midget in there
because
the midget effing the girl or something
yeah he's yeah. going out
and they hide the midget in the closet
I don't know he has like 20 words that rhyme with midget that you're like oh he's probably gonna say midget
there's a widget
there's a widget and I don't know what to say next okay there's a midget He's
I
a fucking
midgets.
Genius shit, yo. Nobody okay. asked me what my favorite
movie is. I did.
Oh,
I
what's
know
your favorite
it
movie?
Vegas in Space.
Well, Vegas in Space is one of my favorites. It's amazing, but that's not my favorite.
I've never seen it.
There's
your favorite
two.
Movie is Carrie.
Barbarella, yeah.
I like Barbarella, but it's not my favorite. It's not Carrie. Even my top 10, but I love Carrie and The Exorcist. I love those movies. And I still haven't seen The Exorcist, The Cut. no, but there's other movies. I know there's more
I'm afraid of the crab on the stairs. I've never seen it, but it's
I
want to
see
me.
That so bad. I love...
The
if there's any two the cinematic she characters goes. I identify with most, it's Reagan from Exorcist and Carrie from Carrie.
Okay. All I right, think it thanks. Would be, for me, I think it would
she
be Scarlett O'Hara,
like, blah, 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 like.
Ingrid Bergman.
Really?
What's her name?
They're
in,
all drunks that died young.
In Casablanca? Young. Like Inez
know,
or...
I don't know. I can't get through that shit, yo. Old, I love old movies, but Citizen Kane is a good movie, but you get like, okay, good, okay, good, okay, good. But did you know that Rosebud was actually
yeah,
Marion Davies' vagina? No, it was, I mean, her clitoris.
I can't believe you think that you're giving us, like, brand new information.
Crystal didn't know, did you?
No.
Rosebud was supposed
yeah,
to have been
I, didn't, to her
I didn't know, and I didn't care,
You
basically.
May as well just have not wasted that 30 seconds I'm of my sorry. Life.
There might be some people that are just discovering that movie that, you know, there's new generations that discover that movie. Let me tell you, Rosebud was actually Marion Davies, who was...
Who's Marion Davies?
Was, what's his name? I can't think of his name right now.
William Randolph
William
Hearst.
William Randolph Hearst.
Who's William Randolph Hearst?
He was Patty Hearst's grandfather. He didn't do anything else besides
Patty
being
Hearst.
Patty Hearst. Patty Hearst. Who's Patty Hearst? Everybody knows who Patty Hearst is. She's
As chaperone,
biggest superstar
I think
of the
I have 70s. To say your date is getting a little boring.
Okay, get on with it. What's the next question?
Okay. Crystal, if you could transport yourself back. Chris, I'm not going to ask you this. I'm going to tell you what the question is and then ask you in 5 minutes. If you could transport yourself back to one day in history, what day would that be? David.
I can't tell you. There's a couple days I would definitely for sure do it, but I can't.
Was it like one of these things where like you were them so you'd have to live it over and do something different? Because that's really douche chilly.
Like
it
like
is
quantum
douche chilly, but that's what I am.
Constantly.
I don't know. Well, then.
Oh my God.
If it can't be that, then I have to rethink it then.
I would go. Okay, eras, not moment, like an era. Like if you
so
could
that you could
this,
just go see
era.
And not participate in then?
No, like you would participate, but you wouldn't be able to change history.
I think the 20s would be pretty good.
20s
but
in
what
America?
Moment though? Like yeah. what? What?
No,
event
no, no. I just
moment?
I changed. The,
she
I changed,
changed
the
question.
Parameters.
What would you do?
I think I'd like to hit some speakeasies and listen to some jazz. I think that'd be
yeah.
Cool.
I'd want to call people ducky and stuff. No, but I would go back to ancient Greece.
and talk to Plato, Aristotle, and Socrates. We all know this. But you couldn't because it would go because you were one of them.
It would be like one of those things
where like one of you, like, you
well, whatever, that's not true, because you remember in the Back to the Future movies where old Biff goes back to young Biff and there's no
but that wasn't real life. You have to do a movie like there was another movie I saw where
and all that happens when Michael J.
Fox Charmed, that's not real life, but if you watch Charmed when like Phoebe and Piper and Prue go back, like the other one, like either that the who they seeing fades or they fade a little because there's no one. You can't be in the same place at the same time because there's only one you.
Or it might be like that. Jet Li movie
science.
Where there were like all these other hymns and all these other dimensions, and one of them went to go to the other dimensions to kill all the other ones. So how do you know they're not going to try to kill you?
Why would he?
So they're the only. Why would he? Socrates or Plato.
Yeah, Socrates might freak out thinking you're coming back in time to kill him. But they wouldn't talk to you because you're a woman.
No, the guy, he went to kill all the other hymns in the other dimension so he could be the only one, so that he could be stronger, because by killing each one in the other dimension, he got stronger and more powerful.
I don't understand. See? Okay, I get it.
Maybe they'll be smarter if they kill you.
But I don't understand why me going back in time to talk to... I don't want to talk to Socrates, or I just want to look around. Jesus.
Yeah, I'd like to see
him
in Greece also.
She wants to see the bathhouses.
I do.
I want to see the people in togas and their togas slip off. Off, and you're like, ooh.
I want to see that they're probably not even wearing togas.
They're just naked. Well, don't you want to go back and see an Olympic Games?
But oh, and they're naked.
Burn out women's eyes, though, if they... That was the punishment.
If they watched?
Yeah, if you watched a naked Olympics, that was a punishment for a woman.
But everyone else could watch a naked Olympics?
Men could,
well,
yeah.
Men, yeah.
Because they're a bunch of homosexuals. So there's no one event, then, that you go back for? Like, the
I'd like to go to the Berlin Olympics.
No, wait, you have to tell where you're stealing this question from, though. So just give proper credit.
No, I didn't steal that question.
Oh, okay. All right, we didn't steal from anywhere.
All right. Next on our date agenda.
The Berlin Wall fall? Is that what you said?
Berlin Olympics.
Oh, the Berlin Olympics. Oh, with Sonja Henie and how she shook Hitler's hand?
Sure. And Leni Riefenstahl.
And Leni Riefenstahl photographed.
I'm just saying names now.
All right, what's your next question? This is a date with David. Getting to know.
Wait, I want to know about everybody's... We were talking about this.
Hold on. Getting to know David and Lindsay. Okay, go ahead. What?
What was your first debilitating crush?
Debilitating crush?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
You know where you're so, like, sprung over somebody you can't think of...
We don't get sprung. That's gross.
Not sprung
you get
like
sprung.
That. It just means, like, you're like, oh my
girl
god,
girl walks
I love that
in
person.
With an
you can't stop thinking about them.
In your face, you get sprung.
You can't stop thinking
do you
about
donuts?
Them and you... Donuts. No. Like, Crystal makes the best homemade donuts in the world.
Oh, thanks.
I'm too chubby to eat cookies. Wait, what was your first bad crush?
Was he Canadian?
I don't know. You're talking about like...
You never had a really bad crush ever?
Well,
I had one
sure,
last week.
But like...
I think it's funny that Canadians get crushes on other Canadians.
Canadians fall in love and marry other Canadians. That's
so weird. And they never think twice about it. Like, you're Canadian, and so am I.
I know. They're just like, all right, whatever.
They're like, I see.
You guys need a hobby.
This is our hobby. Jesus.
No, but think about it. It's not even novel to them. Like, no. Oh, my God, you're Canadian. It's like, it would be ridiculous if you the one of them. Like, if we said that to each other. Oh, my God, you're American. But Lindsay's going out with a... She's like Peter. She's going out with a French dude. And Peter
went out with a
Canadian
French dude.
Peter's going out with a Canadian chick. They went outside of the country. They couldn't find anyone good enough for them.
I slept with everybody in this country before. Oh yeah, that was
this
my question.
Been
am I a slut or not?
You already said you were a slut.
Well,
on a
I think we have to
podcast.
Wait to the end of the date to see if you put out. I think. That's
ooh, the good
okay,
going,
I'm
Crystal.
Previous dates.
So wait, who's your nobody? Who's your first bad crush?
Just tell me if he was Canadian.
Did you ever have any crushes ever?
Yeah, sure.
Was Peter?
Oh, okay,
like
I
your
remember,
first.
I remember. I'm trying to think back as much as I can remember. When I was like 10 or something like that.
Uh huh. Yeah, yeah.
There was this guy that was like, I think he, I don't know. He was like mom's friend's kid or something like that, and he was like 14 or something. And
so he's 4 years older than you?
He was cute. Yeah, he wouldn't have even looked at me, but I thought he was really cute.
Yeah, he shouldn't be looking at 10-year-olds.
Yeah, he should be arrested.
He didn't.
He should
in
be
his
arrested.
Defense. He didn't even look
I
at
had
me.
The same thing. When I was 13, I was in love with a 19-year-old.
So wait, what's his first name?
Don't.
You don't have to say his last name. Oh, you don't remember?
I'm... I, 10 was a long time ago.
It was called Mr. Canada.
All right, who's your last debilitating crush?
The first debilitating crush I had was when I was 13. He was 19. And
what was his first name?
I'm not going to tell you.
Just his first name?
No.
Why, do we still see him?
No, it was just a very, very unique first name.
Kind of
like
give it
Uri
away.
Uri or Pavel or Zaryosha?
But he said, he was the first person who ever said to me, "Oh my God, Lindsay, you're so funny." And then my heart swelled.
Aww.
And he went, "Funny looking." And then it shattered and it's never ever been fully repaired.
That's terrible.
Isn't that horrible?
How did you know him? How did you just hang out with 19-year-olds?
His mom was working for my dad or something. Anyway, and then this other time
he's going to be traced that way now.
Yeah, shut. All right, forget it. It's over.
No, I want to know. So, what happened to you? Were you like?
I was so in love with him, and I really thought that he was in love with me too.
But he had a girlfriend. Like me, you're like me. I'm insane.
He had a hot girlfriend. He was an 18-year-old in a band, and he had a hot girlfriend groupie.
What was her name?
I don't remember, but she's beautiful.
Wait, my sound just went out. Are we still on? Okay, no, we're not off. We're not off. All right, hey. So wait, how long did you have a big crush on him for?
I don't know, about a month.
Oh, that's
it? Torture. It was torture, though.
I go through like 6 years and stuff.
Yeah, but when you're 13, like...
Yeah.
Yeah, when you're 13, you don't have time to cultivate the insanity. I had one when I was 30.
Peter made Pape wait like 5 minutes for something. I'm like, you jerk. That's like 5 years to her. She's three.
She's three. All right, David, who's yours?
Mine was when I was in high school, and it was Lisa Peters. And it was my whole senior year of high school. And I was really good friends with her brother, hung out with her brother. My locker was 3 lockers away from hers. And all my friends, my cousin who I went to school with and her best friend I hung out with a lot. And they were really good friends with her. I was friends with like everyone she knew. And I remember this like it was yesterday. I gave her my yearbook at the end of the school year and I was graduating. And she wrote in my yearbook. My locker was 3 lockers away from hers. I'd see her like every day. And I was insane. Like, I left roses on her car. Like, I was such a freak, an idiot freak. She wrote in my yearbook, she wrote, "Oh my God, I didn't even know you went to this school."
Oh my God.
I hung out at her house with her brother. We'd go, like, to the movies and stuff in groups, and she'd be in the groups. Like,
invisible.
I know. That's who the hell awful. Did she think I was? I had a couple of conversations with her, but I was a total idiot, and I was just such a.
What do you mean you put flowers on her car?
I put, like, roses on her car with, like...
Explain this to me.
Did you stand in front of her window with it?
I've never told anyone this ever.
Wait, hold on. I'm imagining that you covered her car in rose petals.
No,
I think
one
actually
rose.
You put a rose on the hood of her car, right?
This is what I did with a note of words that I cut out of a magazine, like...
You're
so beautiful or something like that.
I know!
I'm
watching you every second.
She probably did know, but she's probably like,
I'm going to keep it cool.
Get away
Don't
from
make
me.
Direct eye contact.
No, but then she told somebody after that, oh, he's really handsome or something like that. And I was like, whoa. But then she had a boyfriend. But then, I don't know, whatever happened. Then I was like, oh, she's kind of a douche. And then I remember seeing a yearbook. What? She was like, she was blonde and thin and like, she was like a Barbie, like literally like a Barbie. But then I remember seeing a yearbook a year or two later after I'd graduated and thinking like, oh, she's not that beautiful. Because I thought she was amazingly beautiful.
You were blinded by love.
I was blinded by love. But she didn't even, and everybody, it was so funny because everybody told me like, she's really dull. Like, she has no personality. Like,
who
her best
personality
friend.
Personality when you're pretty.
I know,
okay,
totally.
I was thinking about joining the Mile High Club.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe I said the person's full name. Can we get sued for that?
Yeah. Or you'll just be a big douche.
No,
for that.
You didn't say anything bad about her. It's not like slander or anything.
You said that she was dumb.
No, I didn't say that. Her best friend even told me, like, later on, like, you know, she doesn't have any, like, she has no personality. Okay. Yeah. Her best friend told me that.
It's cool. So what were you saying?
She's shutting me up. Crystal's shutting me up.
I don't know how to do it without getting arrested.
Yeah, so
I was reading a news story about somebody this guy fell asleep in his girlfriend's lap, and the stewardess came over and thought he was cunnilingusing her. And they were arrested, and their names were splashed all over the newspapers.
Were they actually arrested, though?
Yeah.
Well,
and so I'm thinking that would be really bad.
The question is, do you mind your name being splashed all over the newspapers?
I do.
Over the
I really
newspapers
do.
For having sex in the airplane?
I do. Oh, okay.
The only thing is, when you get arrested on an airplane, it's serious.
Then what you need to do is you need to become a stewardess. Then you can do whatever you want on the plane. You can have sex with the pilot while he's flying the plane if you want to.
The only thing is, she's going to be on a plane in like.
Can I become a stewardess in 3 weeks?
Three weeks. With her boyfriend.
I have no idea.
I told her that they should just go in the bathroom.
Excuse me, sir. I need to talk to you for a moment. Pull them into the back and have sex with them.
Yeah, I
pull
say that the back, go like to the bathroom. Coach. Or wait, what hours are you flying? Are you flying overnight? Like,
yes.
Yeah, people go to sleep. I would just take them in the bathroom. Wait till it's
quiet. But she's afraid that people are going to see two people
exactly.
in the bathroom.
Exactly. Or, and then this is my worst nightmare, is we're in there doing it, and there's a... And it's the pilot, it's the security guy, the marshal, you know, the guy who brought Kate to the island, and then he got...
Weren't there planes? Maybe they don't have them anymore, where they'd have, like, a little, like, celebrities and stuff. They could have a little segregated with a curtain and stuff. Little area.
Yeah, but
they do have
a little sex nook, if you will.
They have them overnight flights for the stewardesses to sleep in, and chairs that are separated.
Uh-oh, I got cut off again. All right, we're back on. We're back on, ladies and gentlemen. Don't worry.
Anyway, I'm gonna end up getting arrested, I suppose.
I think the bathroom is the best bet. People do it all the time. Maybe in post 9/11 flight, though, you could get busted.
Just don't do it with a box cutter, then you'll get in real big trouble.
Don't do it with a box cutter.
Yeah.
This is what I told her to say. I told her to, like, limp or something like that, or, like, have a colostomy bag. And tell the stewardess, like, he has to go in with me and help me empty my colostomy bag. We'll put it, like, you can just tape it to you and have a little part of the bag.
Got a hole in my colon.
No, not in your colon. Like, tape it to you. Nobody's going to be like, can I look at your colostomy bag? Like, nobody's going to look at it.
The thing is, if I had a colostomy bag, why would I need anyone help? Why would
You'd be like, I need help because it's very painful and I can't do it. I don't know.
Oh, God,
something.
Sick.
or go on with crutches and be like, I need help to get into the bathroom.
I like the way I have a French accent on this.
Well, if you have an accent, well, no, maybe not.
I think
not.
It's just by association. Having sex with a French guy gives you
Seriously.
A French accent.
Well, he doesn't
it's
even
contagious.
Have a French accent.
He has a weird accent.
What do you mean weird?
No, it's fine. He's a very, very handsome young man. What did you think of him, Crystal?
I didn't even really get to talk to him.
He's a really
he's a bit of a snob, I know.
Really? No, he was a snob to you?
No, I just didn't get a chance. I didn't get an opportunity.
Was he rude to you and your daughter?
He came in, I was like, tidying, and then he did his thing and left. And I mean, he was at the other end of the table when we had dinner. Anyway, it's boring. Nobody cares.
Wait, what does producer Peter think of Lindsay's stupid French boyfriend?
I think you should move on to another segment.
I think for the past 5 minutes, Lindsay even yawned.
All right, yeah, we need actually. Where's the freaking entertainment report? All right.
So what else is on your grocery list?
Are we going to go through everything? That's your whole idea, everything?
Oh, no, I did want to steal a bit from Ricky Gervais and Stephen Merchant's
what is
thing.
Say?
But
ladies and gentlemen, remember, coming up soon, a trip through Lindsay's mind.
The thing is, it's very important, and I think we should all think about it a little bit more.
What?
Here's the thing. If we had to colonize a new planet, which 5 people would you want to take with you?
And this is a ripoff from them?
Yeah, totally.
Ooh, okay. That's good.
But it can't
actually.
Be like, I'd like to take my husband and my daughter. Because that's stupid.
Well, that's because you don't have a husband and daughter. Obviously, I would like to take my husband to colonize a new planet because I'm already colonizing this planet with him, okay?
With a Canadian offspring.
It's an obvious choice.
Okay, but this isn't about obviousnesses.
Well, for her, it would be two more people. So what 2 people would you want to copulate and populate a planet?
I don't
then.
Think that you have to copulate. It's not like you're repopulating the planet. You're like there's different reasons. Like, you'd have to bring Harrison Ford because he's a carpenter. You'd have to bring
Harrison Ford's not a carpenter.
Are you sure?
Yes, he is a carpenter. That's how he got his job on Ghostbusters.
On Ghostbusters? Harrison Ford worked on Ghostbusters?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I never knew that. See, you learn things here on so who would the 2 people be then for you, Crystal?
I don't know. Wouldn't that give me 3, though?
No, because you'd have Peter.
No, she can't bring Peter and Pape. I'm sorry.
No, but she said she was going to do it. You'd let her.
No, she said no, and she can't do it. It's not allowed.
I said that I would bring Peter, obviously, because I'm already colonizing this planet.
You can't.
Why not?
I wish I made this clear to you. I can bring Kelvin, but you can't bring him.
Wait, who would you bring then, stupid?
I would bring... I'd bring, like, a comedian. I'd probably bring, like, Stephen Merchant or something. I'd bring somebody really hot to look at. I'd bring a musician so that I could rock out.
I'd only bring really good-looking people because they can have, like, as you start breeding, you're going to get those people anyways.
Yeah.
It's not like...
We're not talking about breeding. We're talking about entertainment. I don't think you really have to repopulate the planet.
I can't say who I'd bring.
It's... why?
Because I just can't.
Okie dokie. All right, so Jessica's here.
I bring Brad, Angelina, and Lindsay, and Brittany. Not you, Lindsay. Lindsay Lohan.
Of course not. Of course
we'd be done.
That's only 4. You need 1 more.
Oh, I'm bringing... I thought I was one of the 5.
No.
Can I help? Can I come in?
And Who? What?
I don't want to go to this new planet.
No, no husbands, no boyfriends.
Lame. I think we should bring. Wait, who did I bring?
Brandon, Angelina, Brittany, and Lindsay Lohan. Paris.
Rachel McAdams.
I guess Paris. Rachel McAdams. No, but she'd get annoyed.
This is not part of your plan.
See, the, the only thing is Rachel McAdams would get annoyed by all of us because we're all very dim and stupid.
See, it would be more productive for him to repopulate a new planet than for us because it would be faster with him. He can knock up five girls.
He can knock up five chicks. Yeah.
No, but then I think about this. Like, I thought there should be at least another guy because then I think of, like, our kids having kids.
It's like the whole Cain and Abel mystery.
But, yeah.
Well,
so
it's still
going
to... Yeah, yeah, that's true. But, it's a good idea, too, because I thought about, what if you bring all women and then it turns out you're sterile?
Word.
Wouldn't that suck? Yeah. So you should bring one more guy.
Although, I don't want to be on a planet with the only other guy is Brad Pitt, actually. That's not well thought.
Make sure there's a doctor there, because what if you guys sprain your ankles?
Yeah, Paris and those guys will, they're going to have to wear high heels on my planet.
Yeah,
for
you
sure.
Just have
so
to
they for
put
sure
them
will
down.
Sprain their ankles. They'll trip. Ah!
So bring one not very good looking, very
Wait,
virile
we're gonna have
doctor.
This is going to have to be a continuing segment because I'm going to have to do research on this. I'm going to have to bring someone not so good looking. I don't know. Well, this is not well
The thing
through.
Is, how are you going to make food? So you need a cook. What if you guys hurt yourselves? You're going to need a doctor. You need an interior decorator for your hut.
I'm going to need Dr. 90210 because I want a lot of plastic surgery.
Yeah, you're going to need plastic surgery, and you're going to need one of those skin cancer specialists from all the time you're going to spend in the sun.
No, I don't care about
that. Oh, are we on a planet or a deserted island?
I don't know. That's your question. What does your grocery list say?
I think Wait, it's a new planet. I think they were being shipped out into space.
Is there a tropical planet?
No, it's cold.
Being shot out. What did they say? What did Ricky Gervais and those guys say?
I don't remember. I wasn't listening. Oh, no. He said he'd bring Jamie Oliver in case he got peckish.
Ooh.
Who's Jamie Oliver? I have no idea who that is.
Jamie Oliver, the naked chef?
He's a celebrity chef.
Peckish.
But then he also would bring Nigella Lawson in case he needed a change. She's another celebrity chef.
That's Ricky said that?
No.
Ricky himself thinks he's chubby, but if he came to America, he'd be normal. If he came to America and lived in, like, Houston, or he'd be thin. He'd be quite thin. He said that?
Yeah.
That son of a bitch.
I know. It's annoying.
He's not supposed to know that.
I know. It's annoying when he says it, but it's okay. Because he was like, I'm feeling really fat on the Jon Stewart show. And he's like, you're here in America. It's fine. Everybody's like, I know. I fit right in. He's like, oh, they're huge here. They weigh, like, 45 stone, whatever that means.
45 stone. 45 times 14. That's...
That's a lot.
Can anybody figure that out really fast?
I have a beer. Why
it's like 6,000 pounds. I don't think anyone weighs 6,000
Not 6,000. It's about 420 pounds.
45 times 15?
No, that's wrong. 400 and, it's 400 and something pounds. Almost
it's like
500
600
pounds. Can you figure that out? 45 times 14, please.
Right, oh,
Jesus Christ, my brain. My brain. Do you have anything else, Lindsay? Or should we go to our entertainment report?
What is it? 45
Six.
Times what?
45 times 14.
14 and a half.
Most people can figure this out in their brain.
Yeah, it's like 600 and something.
675, isn't it?
652,
is that
right? I can't
see it. Yeah,
652. Oh, okay. 652 pounds, ladies and gentlemen. So Ricky Gervais thinks that of Americans. He's still brilliant. He's still quite brilliant. But
even though he's really judgmental.
He's very judgmental. Well, they are superior to us in intellect, I guess. No, in accents, they're superior to us, so. All right, we're going on to the table report because I'm getting the high sign. All right, so here's Jessica with the entertainment report.
Okay.
Hi, Jessica.
Okay.
Hi, Jessica.
Jessica.
How are you doing today, stupid?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Ready, go.
Okay, so one of your planet people are Lindsay Lohan. Apparently, it's official. She her publicist confirms that she's going to AA meetings.
Yeah.
Get out of town.
No.
No, are you kidding me?
Lindsay's not surprised.
Yeah.
That's so awesome.
And
then
Lindsay's like, wait, I thought I saw her there.
Lindsay Williams cannot lose another one to this devil disease.
Devil talk.
Sobriety.
The only thing about AA is, I think AA people are wonderful. The only thing that I don't like is the first thing they say is, it's beyond our control.
What is? You gotta understand.
Well, you could be anything and say it's beyond my control.
Well, but yeah. I think that's what they have to do is admit that they know that it's out of control, beyond their control, so that they can
no,
then
but
take
they
steps
think that
to,
never,
to prevent it.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're an AA, call in or write in to MySpace, LCD podcast, whatever, and tell me if I'm wrong, but they think never, you can never be in control of it. You're always out of control of it.
That's the thing, and that's why just complete abstinence is the way, the only way they can handle it. Because what's the line? One drink is too many and a thousand is not enough. Or
well, Lindsay, you're an alcoholic. What do you think about all that?
I think one drink is too many and a thousand is not enough. One day at a time. Let go and let God?
Let go and let fucking God.
Okay, so what happened?
I think AA people are wonderful. No, I've known some very wonderful.
Kicking the wrong person. I'm trying to kick David, but I'm kicking Lindsay instead.
You're kicking me?
I'm trying to.
Oh, you want me to shut up? All right, ready and go.
Okay, well, in response to the Michael Richards racist rants, apparently Gail let it slip that on her XM radio show, Gail is Oprah's best friend.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Yeah, hello.
Oh, Gail has her own XFM radio show.
So yeah. What did she say? She let what slip?
Anybody could have their own show, even us.
Yeah. She said, in the privacy of my own home, my closest friends who shall remain nameless, we have used that word when we are talking about other people. So
right
why would she admit to that?
Right on. Yeah. She's a right on sister.
Why would she admit to that? I don't understand.
What do you mean? People don't use those words? I grew up in it. I can't say because Crystal's
gonna I've heard you use those
but
words
I grew up
like
in an
all
Asian the household and think of the Asian slurs you can think of and we use that in our household.
But it's different. Asians don't get upset.
Yeah, they do. They're yeah, all like, it's yeah, on your ass.
It's still rude and judgmental.
Yeah.
And
stereotypical.
You know what? That right on. I think that's awesome that Gail said that. Like. Big
go, Gail! It's your birthday. Do we still say that? Because I don't
know. What Oprah say? What Oprah well, say?
She goes. Gail continues to say. I go back and forth between using it as a term of endearment and it being just a very hateful, bad thing.
Right on.
That makes no sense at all. These people need to
right
make up their minds.
On.
They need to make up their fucking minds.
I say right on, Gail. I want to give her a hug.
What are you talking about? How can a one word be very endearing?
She's just not jumping on the bad wagon saying, that's horrible. She's saying, you know what? We use it, okay? Grow up. She's awesome. She's
yeah,
right
she's
on.
Not
she's a rocking
saying that
bitch.
It's okay that Michael Richards said that.
No, she's not, but she's saying, like, it's not the worst
I don't care
thing ever.
One way or the other.
All right, continue. Ready? Go.
Okay, so Lane Garrison, who plays Tweener on Prison Break.
What the hell is this?
Tweener? Is that, like, the 9 to 13 crowd?
Yeah, I know, huh? A lot of people love it, but yeah, what did he do?
Basically, wait, 9 to 13.
Basically, that's tweens. Not teen, not
no, I think
teen.
That's his name. Plays Tweener yeah. on Fox's Prison Break. I think that's his name.
The crowd.
He's 26, by the way, and he had two 15-year-old girls and a 17-year-old boy in his car, and they got into a wreck, and the 17-year-old boy died.
That's horrible. Why are you reporting this?
That's the worst
thing
ever.
Died.
Now
I'm so... I hate hearing about
why
kids dying.
Why did he have these kids in his car?
I don't
all right, Jesse, you're banned. I want Peter. Can you tell the entire news staff they are banned from reports of kids dying? I can't take it.
Wait a minute. What did he have all these kids in his car for? My mind automatically goes to something dirty.
Were they like nieces and nephews
and
stuff?
Nephews, brothers, and sisters.
I
hate
that. I listen to Dr. Laura all the time, and in between they always talk about like a baby died this week. Someone threw it over a fence. It's like, why are you telling us that? I swear to God, this week they said that some woman threw a baby over a fence. But it's like, why do you need to report that?
I don't like babies in trash.
That is not helping anyone. I can't take it. No more.
And I don't like it when people tie their kids up and then they leave them there.
Peter. Producer Peter, the next newscaster on the staff that reports a baby dying, fire them immediately. All right, continue on, please.
Basically, that's it for the entertainer report.
You left us with the dying kid?
I'm so sorry.
Make up something else, then. Say something else. What about the whole Britney scandal with her no underwear?
I know! I've seen Britney's crotch 15 times this week!
I want to see it. I haven't seen it. I've been looking and I haven't seen it.
Oh my god, go to thesuperficial.com.
The Superficial. I'm going to try that out. That's what
it
you should have
incredible.
Brought that out. I love
Britney
Spears.
And there's
Britney
no
Spears.
Hair on it at
she
all.
She looks good. She looks good.
Those extensions
lately.
Are giving me a little
but I'm
nausea.
Looking at that. I was looking at her knockers. She has good knockers. And
yes,
she's
she
pretty. I'm sorry. She's pretty. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. She's
you
pretty.
Should be sorry.
Well, yeah. She's not the ugliest person you ever saw in your whole life.
No, no. This is the first time she's looked pretty
she
in like 5 years.
Her home videos with Kate.
Did you see those?
She had no makeup on. Her hair was all a mess.
Yeah, she's smoking and she's all like trash.
That was not
she's
attractive.
Yeah. I think her mother and her people that handle her should have got hit in the head with a bottle because to be like her mother should have sat her down and be like hell no you're not marrying.
Well,
Kate
that's Bennett. Apparently what they did for them to break up. Her family apparently did an intervention.
They
really?
Should have done it before,
yeah. Well, that was the rumor.
Disaster.
Anyway, I don't know really, but
I want to have
it's word on the street.
What? You want another beer?
No, I got dry, producer.
Peter's trying to be all coy.
All right, and so what do you got next? Are you? Wait, I think we have in the studio of Jessica the Game Girl. Is that what we have?
Jessica the Game Girl? Is she here?
Welcome here, Jessica the Game Girl.
Oh, hi. Hey, thanks.
And here's Jessica the Game Girl.
Okay, well, starting off with Hot or Not.
Hot
this
or
is
not.
My favorite game.
It's Shod or Po. Oh, wait, okay, wait, shot. Wait, how's it?
Shot
au pas.
So last week.
Wow, Producer Peter speaks French fluently.
He just has a good memory.
Shot au pas.
From last time he did it on the podcast.
Are ready? Go.
Okay, Will Smith.
Not.
What?
Will Smith.
For Hot or Not?
Yeah, shot au pas.
You don't think Will Smith is hot?
No,
that's why we said not.
I think he's funny.
Okay, I say hot.
Oh, wow.
Okay, whatever.
Oh, she likes dark meat, I guess.
Oh, Will Smith also just recently
don't call him Michael, whatever.
Will Smith has not sent his children to school because he thinks that they don't need to learn anything. They need just to learn how to learn stuff, and then they don't need to be in school.
What?
If they're interested and they take their own initiative and they
need to go to
try
school.
And
they
learn
need to go to school.
Things.
They need to go to school.
And they have somebody
they need
who
to go
can
to school.
Teach them
and
things.
He said that if he read a book
like
on
a
flying a jet engine, that he could jet airplane, then he could figure it out.
What? I didn't hear what you said.
And he also said he's going to run for the president of the United States.
The Will Smith?
Yeah. He didn't say recently. He said like 10 years ago.
They
look how that turned out.
We're right up to date.
I'm sure they have like
a tutor.
Yeah, I'm sure they have a tutor, but still.
Okay. Natalie Portman.
Hot.
Very hot.
Hot.
She's beautiful.
I'm going to be playing hot.
Yeah, okay. You think she's hot too, Producer Peter? She's very
and
hot.
And she's the shortest woman alive.
She's a tiny bit of an idiot. I've read some things about...
Yeah.
About she's
pro...
Israel. She's pro-Israel.
We're all pro-Israel. Just kidding.
Pro-Israel.
Okay, so Natalie Portman can be a douche, and she's still hot, but Will Smith can't, and still be hot.
I don't think Will Smith is a douche. I think he's funny, but I'm just not into him.
I believe Lindsay said douche.
I don't want to knock that out of the park. You know,
welcome to Miami.
George Clooney.
Hot.
He's hot. He's the new Cary
but
Grant.
When I saw him in that movie Solaris, was it Solaris? Where he was doing the outer space, supposed to be 10-hour movie or something. It's a remake of that Russian film,
okay.
10 hours.
Je never
he had that skin that looked saggy and old, and it looked like he had
like
bad
this?
Old breath.
Are you looking at my face?
No, like you know, mostly you
I
can
have
tell,
that
shut up,
on
like,
my clothes.
On like men, like.
Yes!
It wasn't waddly, but it was just a little bit loose right here.
I think part of the thing with George Clooney is that he's single and he's like this swinging bachelor.
Yeah, that's hot.
I think if he got married, he would lose some of his hot credibility.
Yeah.
I like that he was never going to get married. I think he shouldn't get married. He's so rich. He's so attractive.
Now, do you people think he's
Italian
the do you
Italian
think he's,
villa in Lake Como.
Do you think he's the Cary Grant of the new millennium, like Vanity Fair said?
Sure, why not?
Did you see the Vanity Fair spread with him? He just looks so good.
Really?
I think he got a lot of plastic surgery.
Do you think he could?
It sounds like George Clooney's winning right now.
Yeah, George.
Okay,
well,
so
no, Natalie Portman's beautiful, and she's young.
I'd rather sleep with George Clooney.
What are you, bad?
Stephen Dorff?
Stephen Dorff?
What? Hell no.
Where did this come
hell
from?
No, I hate Stephen Dorff.
Were you like your Teen Beat from 1987?
It was Bop, actually.
Bop.
I hate
she borrowed
him.
It from David.
Okay, Keira Knightley.
Hot.
She's beautiful.
Except for in Pride and Prejudice, her wig didn't fit her properly, and you could see all the little hairs hanging
but
out of
the
back.
But she was sprinkled with god dust, wasn't she?
What?
Well, you, ladies and gentlemen,
Daily Show. It's
this is the first Hot or Not where everybody's actually hot. This is
I know,
our decision
hot.
Of hotness.
Last time, what was it, Philip C. Riley or whatever?
She just mentioned the last podcast. Anyways, I didn't... All right, forget it. Keep going.
Okay, everybody's still hot, then. Okay, Keanu Reeves?
Not.
I don't know what to... All right, Keanu Reeves, what? Nothing.
Did Peter just say hot for
Keanu Reeves?
Are we not
allowed to talk about... Other podcasts?
No, I have something to break to you, and I was going to break it at the beginning of the podcast,
well,
but
wait,
I'm going to wait.
Finish the Hot right, or Not,
sorry,
and then you can break
what?
It.
What?
No.
Finish let's
finish
Hot or Not.
Finish.
No, ladies and gentlemen, we've had
finish
looks
him.
Going across
okay,
the
it.
Table of inside jokes, but we're going to finish the...
Wait a minute, are we
there's
not
a cliffhanger.
Allowed?
Stay tuned.
What? I need to know!
No, stay tuned. Keanu Reeves.
She said not. You need to speak.
Keanu Reeves, he's...
I'm less interested in this game. Let's move on to the cliffhanger.
No, come on. Let's finish Hot or Not. Keanu Reeves
almost
is
done.
Decent looking. He's better looking than I am, so I give him a hot.
So you don't think Will Smith is better looking than you are?
No, I don't. He's goofy looking.
Let this go, David.
Am I that bad looking?
No. Oh my God.
No,
Will
just
Smith is better. Will Smith is hot. I do.
He is. Yeah. Will Smith is goofy looking to me.
I know.
He's
he
fine. He's funny. He's great. I'm sorry. I don't want to knock
him out. That's because you watched Fresh Prince, and you probably have that image of him with his.
With the big ears and stuff.
Yeah, making goofy faces.
Wait, why can't I watch the last?
Who's next on Hot or Not?
Okay, Heather Graham.
Hot.
No, she's the bitch is the rash.
I think she's not. Like, she seems nice and she seems funny, but she's not, she's okay. I mean,
ladies,
she's pretty, but yeah.
I wrote a book called Bombshell: The Blonde Phenomenon of the 20th Century. I know you don't know anything about it.
Shameless,
but she didn't
self-promotion.
Make it. She's blonde and she didn't make the book.
Okay, Shane West.
Who's that?
Oh, yeah, he's kind of hot.
Wait, he's
Once and Again, right?
Wait, is he the one that's playing Darby Crash in the Germs
movie? He also, I don't know, he was in A Walk to Remember. Did you guys ever hear that movie with Mandy Moore?
I'm an adult.
Okay.
Oh.
Fuck you, Lindsay. Fuck you. I didn't know you saw that movie.
I can't believe you're snapping.
I can't believe you're snapping. I'm snapping all the 14-year-old girls.
Do you want the wrath of Canada on your ass? Do you really want that? I don't know. We don't know who that is.
She's trying to kill me.
I don't know.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
What else has he been in?
I don't know.
Is he in?
He was in the show Once and Again.
What is that?
It was a drama with Cella Ward and blah, blah.
Oh, I have no idea what
anyway,
that is.
Whatever.
He doesn't get any votes because we don't
know. I gave him a vote.
Oh, he got one vote.
Okay. Jenny McCarthy.
Oh.
Hi.
Wait,
hot.
I think he might be on ER.
Shane West?
Yeah.
I haven't seen it.
I haven't seen ER since they got rid of, what's
his name? Is it still on? It's still on?
Yeah.
Well,
Jenny McCarthy, I give
show.
A not.
I love Jenny McCarthy.
I hate Jenny McCarthy.
I love out of control, insane, hot chicks with big boobs. There's nothing better than that.
Nothing better than big boobs.
Okay, and Lisa Kudrow.
You know that's true, Jessica.
Jessica, ladies and gentlemen, has double Ds.
Lisa Kudrow.
Lisa Kudrow.
Not.
She's funny, but she's not.
She's funny.
I'm
she's
sad. Nice. I wanted not, Lisa Jenny McCartney to win.
So you had George Clooney, Natalie Portman, Keira Knightley. All really hot. You give them all three hot. So you got to.
Nobody wins. All right, good. Moving on.
Who do you
think
of those
three? Natalie Portman's really beautiful. Natalie Portman beats Keira Knightley because Keira Knightley's older.
I don't care. George Clooney wins.
Wait, they have to win.
You're a total pedophile. Because Natalie Portman's older.
No, but she's over 25.
Wait, he's a total
pedophile.
No,
Keira Knightley's 35 and Natalie Portman's 25.
105. Yeah, so that makes
you a pedophile. I'm 52, all right?
52.
She's half my age. Pedophile. So wait, who do you vote for? I vote for Natalie Portman. Who do you vote for?
I don't know.
George Clooney is the only guy in the bunch. Come on.
Oh, come on, don't be a fag, Crystal.
I know. I'm sorry, but I like the dick.
Oh, no.
Okay, George Clooney, yeah.
Damn!
Okay.
So,
now, Natalie Portman and Keira Knightley, they're pretty, but they
who
both
won
kind of look similar.
Rachel
they're
McAdams
kind of like the
won
same.
Last okay. time.
George Clooney beats Rachel McAdams.
Yeah.
I don't know. I vote for Rachel McAdams.
I think Keira Knightley, Natalie Portman, and George Clooney beat Rachel McAdams.
No, I love Rachel
each
McAdams.
Each individually.
Yeah, Natalie Portman, I think beauty-wise, would beat Rachel McAdams.
I don't care!
But Rachel McAdams is sexier.
No, she's
not sexy.
Okay,
she's
so
sexier sexy. Than Natalie Portman.
You've
you
seen one movie with Rachel McAdams, and it was Mean Girls.
I saw the hot chick.
Oh God,
she was hot and hot. She was the
you
hot.
You have the
chick
worst
the
taste
chick.
In films
no,
of all
no.
time. I thought that my boyfriend had the worst taste.
I didn't think she looked good with blonde hair at all. I thought she looked terrible with blonde hair.
I love hair.
Oh.
I love hair.
But Natalie Portman is classically beautiful.
I don't care.
Okay, so George Clooney wins.
Sucks.
And Natalie Portman's really funny,
high
too.
High five, Crystal.
See, ladies and gentlemen, there's a secret around the table going on that Lindsay's not a part of, and I thought she would pick it up with the Rachel McAdams, but she didn't. It didn't click at all.
Did Rachel McAdams not win last time?
Let's just wait till if she can figure it out by the end of the podcast. Look at, oh God, I love this face on Lindsay, the like, uh-oh, there's something I don't know. Like,
I hate
she's
this!
She's ready to take a knife out of her purse.
What happened to
okay,
the last podcast?
Okay, this is what happened. The last podcast...
Got erased?
It's even better.
All right,
wait, just make
happened.
Her guess. Just make her guess.
Well, she'll never guess.
I'll never guess.
She might. You never
okay,
know.
Okay, the last... Okay, do you remember what happened Monday and Tuesday last week?
Oh, you did another podcast.
We
without
Lindsay
me.
And I were in a huge fight, and I called Peter, and I said that Lindsay and I were in a huge fight. And he said, get over here right now and do podcasts. Let's get over here.
I can't believe it!
But then I said, oh shit, like, because we made up, but right before the podcast. Like, I thought we were going to carry the final.
What are we getting into a fight about?
Because you called me up and you apologized and you said, yes, it's my fault. And I know, and I couldn't continue the fight.
Oh my God! Oh my God, you're the biggest child of all time!
But we came on to the podcast and we did a segment called Let's Talk Shit About Lindsay. And we all came up with something. including Crystal had something too.
Crystal! And I didn't even make the walk to remember remark yet. Jessica
couldn't. That's where we have the new Hot or Not on Rachel McAdams. That's where she won.
Yeah, she won the one before.
Oh, she did?
She won twice in a row.
Wait, who almost won that?
Oh, so I'm such a fucking idiot.
Oh, shit. I thought that she won that time. Who won? Wait, someone who won the last one? Who did Rachel McAdams?
I knew it! You said it was for your stupid faggy movie!
Wait, what?
Your little faggy movie!
What faggy movie?
The thing with the dude and the two guys making out!
I thought you were just being slandered.
I don't know what she's talking about. I don't know what she's talking about at all.
I'm never gonna trust you again. Now I know how everybody else
I don't know
feels.
What you're talking about.
She's
now.
Talking about dude with the...
Dude, what the fuck?
Wait, what about that stupid movie?
You said you came over here to do a song for that. And you're lying! You came over here to do a podcast!
No. That night I did come over to listen to the song, actually.
And to do a podcast!
But we thought it would be funny, but I guess it's not. Well, anyways, we talk shit about you through the whole podcast.
You should check it out. Go to MySpace.
How do you feel? www.adammonster.com.
Click on LCD Podcast.
I feel so...
I believe it's episode number 6.
I don't even
six.
Know you people!
Are you actually really mad? What are you feeling? Come on, talk us through it.
I feel ashamed. I feel betrayed. I feel a little chubby. I'm a little hungry.
That's what she hears. We did the podcast without you, and Lindsay hears, "You're fat!"
Aww.
Oh, Jessica pities you.
I'm too fat for friends.
I'll give you two consolations. We all talk shit about you, except for that Jessica said that she didn't have anything to say because she's a little afraid of you.
Good move, Jessica. I'll remember that when I take over the
Mark
world.
Said something, but then it actually turned out that he's like, wait a minute, like it was a compliment. We were like, you're stupid.
What did you say about me?
I'm not going to tell you. You have to
listen
to the podcast.
You know what? You're such an idiot. You know why David was mad at me? You guys, he's just a big, whiny little bitch. Because I didn't talk to him enough at a party.
No, that's not what happened.
Oh, I feel bad. And I'm not to me. I see him every day. I talk to him 15
times. Did I not do that on the podcast?
Yeah.
I did exactly what you just did on the podcast.
He was 17,000 times a day. You realize how high my phone bill is? I see him at a party where I don't get to see any of my other friends. My stupid French boyfriend's in town. And David leaves because he's upset.
Oh. I did this whole invitation of you.
Baby.
I know you like a fucking book, bitch. But you will be happy when you hear it because we actually found a Lindsay impersonator and it was eerie. Like, the person was dead on.
Who?
Like, we all were sitting there going, like, oh my god,
you're
is
just
going
to have to listen
room?
To it.
It was amazing. It was dead on. Because then we did.
Tell me right now.
They even wore a blonde wig and it was almost like
did?
I was looking
dead
at you.
On. You have to see. You listen
you're going
to
have to listen to it.
I don't want to ruin it for you. I don't want
to
ruin it for
you. I'm
not
going to listen to it.
I don't.
You know what? Right now, you're just giving Peter Moore to edit. Who did it? Who did it? Who did it? Just listen.
Listen to me, and because we brought the Lindsay impersonator in because I recreated the whole fight.
You are so embarrassing. How do you live with yourself?
I don't know.
You realize that he's a big baby and he comes on the podcast and complains about me.
We talk shit about you the whole podcast, yes.
You know what? The next time you do nothing to me, I'm going to schedule a podcast and talk shit about you.
Are you kidding? If you called Peter and said, I hate David and we're never talking again, he'd be like, get over here right now. We're doing a podcast.
Yeah.
And Peter was mad at me because we made up. He's like, what's wrong with you?
We made
he
up
told me not to
podcast?
Take your calls. Yeah, we made up just before the podcast. He said, don't take your calls. He got mad at me for taking your calls. But what kind of did she call? And she apologized for everything. She said, I know I'm a horrible person.
I did not apologize.
I was drunk. I was on my period.
What? You kept calling me over.
She's lying.
Peter,
shut up.
He called me so much. I swear to God. And this is one of the times where, because I usually apologize, and this is one of the times where I didn't, where I was like, I don't give a fuck, because he's just being a big baby.
That's not true. She's lying.
It's totally fucking true.
Wait till you hear the reenactment, and you'll see what really happened. All right. Wait, do you have any more games?
I have another game.
What is it?
Okay, it's Would You Rather.
How do you say that in French?
Qu'est-ce
que tu...
French. Like that.
Would you rather do it with a Frenchie or with David? Frenchies! Would you rather throw David off a cliff or have world peace? Throw David off a cliff!
Oh dear.
Stop it!
A forever face full of acne, like even when you're like 90.
Oh, jeez.
Or drink urine every day.
My urine?
Yes.
How much?
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
8 ounces.
Can I filter it?
How much
with
is this?
Through like a Brita? 12
this
times?
This is practically like drinking urine, isn't it?
Okay, how about a whole beer bottle full every day?
This is 12 ounces.
No, that's 12. No, no.
So it's like 3/4 of this.
Okay, yeah.
Can we filter
urine.
It?
Can
urine
I tell you
sterile.
Something?
Urine
we have a
sterile,
friend.
It's fine. It's good for you, actually.
But it's not going to taste good. If
friend.
I filter it, then I could mask the taste.
No,
can
no, you guys. People go pay.
Well, who's going to know? You know, honestly, can't you just, like, pretend you're drinking it and throw
listen
it in the sink?
Me. People pay to have that urine therapy done. We have a good friend, the two of us, that went and did
got
that
injected.
For months. I would
I know,
do that.
I
it's
have,
supposed to be cured
I know
you.
Two guys
no,
who did that,
I know a
too.
Lot of people with
they
acne.
Went to this coffee shop, and this guy was peeing in their coffee.
Are you kidding? Are you serious?
And then, no, I'm serious.
It? Where?
It's a place called Caldy Coffee in Atwater Village, California.
Didn't you make us go there for your shows?
The guy, the guy doesn't work there. The guy doesn't work there anymore.
How did you find out about peeing? Did he hate those guys?
His girlfriend told him. No, it was Peter and Mark are the guys.
And the guy hated you?
He did it at first when he didn't really know them, and he had this idea that whoever ordered dark roast coffee was an asshole, so he'd pour a little pee in their coffee.
So he was a psychopath.
So he'd yeah. pee at work or something?
No, he'd like pee in a cup, and he'd just keep it behind the counter and just add it as he went along.
Oh, my
God. His girlfriend spilled the beans to Peter and Mark because they
he
were
works
all...
in a coffee joint?
Why would why would a girl still go out with a guy that does that?
When I don't know.
When you break up with a guy, you pour pee...
Maybe he had, he had good pot or something.
I don't understand. And, oh, my God.
So did
God.
You guys have a rest? You know that's a felony?
Did you get your stomach pumped?
No. No, but he felt... They both felt nauseous for like 2 weeks. They like hardly ate anything. And they were all sickly looking.
Wait,
it's
do you
hot.
Know that? You should have. Did you call
or
the
not.
Police? That's a felony. Did you know that?
Yeah.
You didn't care? What'd you do to him?
We contacted him. We contacted the owner of the store, and they're like, no, yeah. he didn't. But I'm like, we were friends. He admitted it. And yeah, nothing.
They're like, no, he was just joking. They wouldn't believe him. He didn't have any proof.
When I
told him he should go with
like,
a little...
you didn't get sick. You never got sick. And he got all defensive. And I
oh
thought he was joking.
Oh, my God.
Around.
He's a psychopath. That was so scary. Could you imagine? Well, it didn't make you sick. Me peeing in your coffee. So why are you mad at me?
You should have filed a police report. I peed in Lindsay's coffee and we didn't get a fight over that. Oh, you didn't know that? Oh, sorry.
That was also brought up in the podcast.
Seriously! I thought it was beer. You know what? If the podcast just turns into let's try to torture Lindsay, then that I think that's good radio.
Well, you're crazy.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
Would you rather bathe in elephant snots or be locked in a studio listening to Ashley Simpson's music?
I love Ashley Simpson.
Ashley Simpson. Yeah, I think Peter has all her albums.
Pieces, sing it. Pieces,
yeah, on Monday, I called
Tuesday,
you. On Tuesday, I paid you. On Wednesday, I don't know, something.
Text.
Pieces of me.
What about that song?
Fuck yeah.
What's that Hillary Duff song? So yesterday. Is that Hillary
yeah.
Duff?
Yeah.
That's a great song.
Great song.
And we heard the tide is high. That's such a ripoff. The even if the stars are blind, even if the gods are crazy, if you show me your vagina,
you
I'll show you mine. That
Paris
is a ripoff of the
you
tide
guys,
is high.
Why you really? I gotta listen to
totally.
That.
The tide is high.
You didn't really think that she wrote her own stuff, though, did
no,
you?
No, no, no. But I didn't think she had to be so derivative.
She wrote
yeah,
that song.
She
no.
Did. No. She had somebody else write a song that was a ripoff of another song.
Exactly.
Oh. Aren't there good...
That's really stupid.
Would you rathers?
Okay. Would you rather...
Oh, okay. Okay, sure. So in this podcast,
sorry, ready?
Shit about Jessica.
Okay, okay, you ready?
I like good. Positive. Like, would you rather
lick,
win $1 million?
Lick a spiky cactus.
Uh-huh.
Or...
Oh, so clean.
Or wait, or lick himself? David's bald head. Or Mark's version, lick David's balls.
You know,
that's not even a real question. Wait,
I think
cactus or David's head?
Yeah,
my balls.
David's balls or cactus?
My spiky
cactus.
Balls. You'd rather lick the spiky like and pierce your tongue?
Yeah, I would rather lick
a
cactus than lick your balls. But if
balls.
I had the choice, I'd rather lick your head than either one because
oh,
you seem like a clean
have
guy.
You see how greasy it is, though?
It's not
like,
greasy.
I'll put my hand on it and
no. Let me see.
It's greasy right now.
Maybe I take it back. Oh, wash it. Oh my God. I have soap. I can wash it.
Wait a minute.
I can pull out the prickles of the cactus.
Wait, Lindsay.
No,
you can't.
You'll get them in your fingers. So sort of defeat the purpose.
Wait, you can stick the head of my penis in your mouth, but you can't lick my balls.
Oh God, I would feel sick. Remember that fly that I ate today? That was better than what you just said.
You ate a fly today? That sounds really good.
I ate a fly.
Lindsay, what's the next one?
Okay. Jessica.
Be married to Roseanne Barr.
I already did this.
Oh, did you?
No,
it was make out.
Or live in a cardboard box on the street.
I'd marry
Roseanne. For how long?
Now.
She's fucking
ever.
Rich.
I'm on my way.
I know marriages last forever. We'd break up.
So yeah. Wait, go ahead. Yeah, what would you rather do?
I'd probably marry Roseanne Barr.
Hell yeah.
She doesn't seem like the
bad. Live in a cardboard box? Where do you go to the bathroom?
In the corner.
In the corner.
Yuck.
How would I get facials and waxing?
All right, continue.
14 children having 14 children under the age of 10.
Uh-huh.
Or clean out septic tanks
I don't even
forever.
Think it's possible to have 14 children if you're under the age of 10.
No. Like all the children are under 10.
Okay. Lindsay is actually pretty funny on that one.
Okay, 14 children under the age of 10 or what?
Or clean out septic tanks for a living.
Oh God!
But how long of a living can you change careers?
No,
and how long are they
can't ever
be
change
time?
Careers?
You can't ever change careers.
How can they be
until
they
retire?
Grow up?
I like the 14 kids running around.
Yeah, I'd probably get 14 kids.
I think you'd get as many bacterial infections from children.
Oh my God! You need to bathe your children, Lindsay.
There's 14 of them.
So bathe them all. Get 14 bathtubs.
God.
My God.
Do like in yours, yours, mine, and ours,
like
where they buy the lighthouse?
Like in the children are on, but close to the ground, so they're very dirty.
Oh my God.
Doesn't make any sense.
Lindsay's going to warp her children.
The difference between children and adults is they don't wash themselves. That's all.
Oh. The whole reasoning and
they're
like,
trying
to kill
themselves.
That's
what I'm doing wrong.
It's a good thing I don't
I'm trying to get them to
I don't
wash.
Know the difference.
It's like Peter, he tries to get Pave to put herself to bed. I'm like, she's three. She's going to stall her ass off.
Peter, are you trying to get her to put herself to bed?
This is boring. Let's move on.
Of all judgmental eye. He's willing to judge me over there, producer Peter.
Okay, wait. So we want a positive one?
Yeah, are there any positive ones? Like would you rather touch my double D's or fondle David's hot little rod? I mean, go ahead. Yeah, what?
I think everyone in this room would rather touch my double D's.
Yes!
Oh my God. She's so stuck up.
No, please, baby.
Uh-oh, someone sorry. Pulled me out. That someone pulled me out. What do I do? All right,
that's
kind of
hot. Jessica's all like tossing her hair.
I know. Like a porn, the porn star toss.
I don't, hey, I thought maybe you could play like one time I never, but there's not enough beer for you guys to drink. And
yeah, and I have to go to the bathroom.
I don't know how to do I never. Oh, wow. Lindsay's just out like a shot. That's it. Well, we'll be back right after this. Oh, all right. Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have special... It took a lot of doing
special
to get these people in the
Olympics.
Studio, but we have special guests in studio. One of my favorite bands. I actually was in the band, but I got kicked out, so it's hard for me to look at you people sometimes.
You quit.
I got kicked out for being too fat.
You quit.
I didn't quit. I got kicked out. Peter
you
said I was too
fat.
Peter gave me a month
you are too
to lose
fat,
10 pounds.
But you did
I couldn't
quit.
Do it, and he kicked me out.
You are too fat, but that's not the reason. The reason is you're stupid.
All right, so ladies
and
gentlemen.
And you're mean, and you're backbiting and double-crossing.
Wait, before we get into the Orange Monkey Report, Lindsay, you're still upset that we had a podcast without you and talk shit about you behind your back in front of your face?
Yeah.
We talked shit about you through the whole podcast.
You're a douche, chill.
How do you feel? What are you going through? What are the emotions you're going through right now?
You already asked her that.
I'm a little hungry.
No, I know, but she's hungry.
See, this is wrap it up. Wrap it up, David.
What?
All right, so wait. Why don't you introduce yourselves? Who do we have here? Wait, shh.
They're all unsalted, right. Though.
Orange Monkey, shh.
Enough about
unsalted
your nuts.
Raw cashews or...
Oh, no, you guys think
Ixnay on the Utsnay.
You're like, ooh, maybe, but not
real
nuts.
Did you like a large wiener?
And some eggs.
Oh, we almost saw a beer spilled. Okay, so who do we have in studio from Orange Monkey?
So,
Marcus Aurelius.
I am not Marcus Aurelius. I am MC Ryan.
And what do you do?
Of Orange Monkey. Let's introduce everybody first.
You should say who you are and what you do.
I do everything.
All right, next.
This is.
I'm the band Nazi, Peter.
Well, fuck you. You know what? Fuck you.
This is bullshit. Have an in-studio fight.
I'm going to come in your mouth.
Not tonight.
And what's your name, young lady?
I'm Crystal, and I play all the token instruments.
You play the triangle?
Yeah, I actually do play the triangle.
Just the Linda McCartney.
The tambourine, the keyboard. Occasionally, they let me play drums.
So how are we so lucky to get you guys in the studio? On tour right now?
Yeah, like, what are you guys doing in this neighborhood?
You have to get in, get out. What's going on?
Well,
because we are recording this in the Orange Monkey Studios. That's quite a coincidence.
It is a coincidence. You guys are called Orange Monkey.
Yeah.
Actually, weird, the studio right? stole the name from us. We were thinking about suing, but we talked to them. That guy, Peter, he's actually pretty nice. So we let it slide.
Peter the producer.
Aki is in the band. It's Aki. Yeah, you're mixing up names.
Look, I hate to tell you, but this is going to be a very hard-hitting interview. I have very hard-hitting questions.
Oh, okay.
Now, Crystal, I am very good friends with Peter and Mark,
lame.
And we've had discussions when you're not around.
Lame. Mm-hmm.
And they said that you actually don't like the music.
Oh, the last song that you guys, that they did, they were doing for your gay movie.
Baggy.
And,
it's actually a man and a woman that make out.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. That was
that was
the one straight movie you did.
Yeah, the other
That's
ones
right,
are all
right. Okay.
The other guy, the guy was trying to get his friend to give him a BJ.
Right.
Okay.
You know what? So That's not necessarily gay. That's just two guys hanging out in a park. Anyways, go ahead, Crystal.
So the straight movie
yeah,
that we did.
Yeah, so go ahead.
They made a song, and they asked if I thought it was a good dance song, and I didn't. I didn't think it was a good dance song. I didn't say it was a bad song.
Oh,
I just
didn't
think it was a good dance song.
What did you think of the song?
I thought it was
Becky. Wait, hold on. Let's talk
you
about
thought
the.
It was
let's
ass.
Talk about the.
No, no.
Wait, why
is it
called
song?
Dude?
It
what the fuck?
I couldn't dance to it.
Wait, that has nothing to do with Orange Monkey. Let's do that after the Orange Monkey interview.
I know, but they like. They're interested.
But the thing is, Crystal, they said they listened to the music and the CDs over and over, and you never have even listened to one all the way through.
Yeah.
So what do you yourself think about Orange Monkey? Because I'm a huge fan. I think you guys are geniuses.
I love some of the stuff.
Osama Bin Laden, and I love Crystal's voice.
Did you know that Crystal hates that song?
Why?
We have to make deals with her to get her to do that song live.
Yeah.
Really? What? Like what?
What kind of deals?
Nuts.
You.
A fisting?
Crystal.
Now he's just giving everything away.
Something should be left.
How strange. This is kind of like when you find out that your idols don't like their own music.
No.
And you feel like an idiot. I feel
like
no.
It would be like if Joey Joe McIntyre said he didn't like Hangin' Tough.
I just don't.
Yeah, we hung out with Joey Joe McIntyre one night, and he told us I didn't like this song, Hanging Tough. I didn't think
friend?
It was a good song. Yeah, isn't that, can
that
you believe
that? That
was
a Romanian accent, obviously.
All right, so
but
Mark.
No, I don't dislike the music. I just don't. I don't know. I'm not the kind of person who
like
sits around and listens to my own stuff all the time.
What do you like?
I want to know why you don't like Osama Bin Laden is in my pantry.
The recorded version. I say Usama instead of Osama, and that bugs the crap out of me.
I always liked that.
Why did
I thought it was a Canadian
situation.
It's because
first
it just
out,
happened. It was very
no one really knew.
It was very topical.
We weren't
even sure how
wrong.
To pronounce it.
Uh-huh.
And then it took
that's
us a year
the,
and a half to
that's how
to
the news
the
report was. Yeah, it was like a long time ago. Anyway, and
you guys, it's like a time capsule.
Yeah, I'm just not.
Thank you, Lindsay.
I don't know. I don't.
Time.
I'm not like, look at me. I don't like to just stand on stage and have everybody
listen. Can you give me the
me.
Lyrics, run down of the lyrics real quick about Osama Bin Laden?
Oh, yeah, and there is a line in there that I'm not fond of.
What is it?
Is it?
So, I
want to shower and then go off to bed, but all of my clean towels are on Osama's head.
I fucking love that.
I love that.
That was
line.
One of the
That's
guys. That was like the only line I didn't
Why don't
write.
You like it?
Because it sounds racist.
It is. You
oh,
see a song about Osama
point.
Bin Laden?
No, I can be mean to Osama Bin Laden, but I don't want to be racist.
It's not even
like,
racist.
I can be culturalist. But I can't. I don't want
to
be
upset about his racist
to everyone
culture.
Who has a turban.
No, you don't want to slander towel heads?
Don't say that.
Honey, there's a lot of cultures that wear towels on their head.
It doesn't mean I can say bad things about them.
Yeah.
What?
Wait, all right, let's continue on. We don't want to make Crystal uncomfortable. She'll fucking
like
bring the wrath of Canada.
I've been all my clean towels. Thomas bed.
Was that head?
About a head, stupid.
But see, I don't know. When they first were talking about it, I was like, oh, okay, because I think of, you know, when you take a shower and you put a towel around your head. I was like, oh, okay, that's funny, thinking that he's like wearing a towel like a girl. And then later, when I thought about it, I'm like, oh, that doesn't sound good.
That is so cute, little Crystal.
I know. It's because she's Canadian.
She's the voice of international peace.
I know. She's
hey, so who are your influences? Who do you like? What bands? Please don't say
right now,
yeah, like Nickelback or anything like
that. I don't really know about influences, but I like
who are your favorite bands?
Death Cab. I like Death Cab. I like Rilo Kiley.
Love me some Death Cab.
I like Bright Eyes.
Love me some Bright Eyes.
All right, awesome.
I don't know.
So Mark,
I like the OC mixes.
Ooh.
Ooh. I love iTunes OC mixes.
They're good.
Totally.
I have no idea what that is, but ooh.
I think
yeah, we're
MC
going
Ryan.
Into the song. Actually, this is your big hit right now that people I'm sure people are familiar with, but we're going to play it. It's like the number one song right now for 4 weeks in a row.
Oh, is this...
What's it called?
For your short? Or,
yeah, you guys actually did a crossover because you are scoring films.
You guys are also protective of your stupid
Lindsay's
notes.
Very immature. We're trying to
let you guys all see my notes and exactly
we're
what
trying
I
to have an
first.
Interview with world famous world famous Orange Monkey. She's ripping things out of Mark's hand.
I was just looking and he slapped my hand.
They're my notes.
Lindsay,
notes for later.
Can we focus on another person besides you for 5 minutes? 5 minutes, that's all I asked.
Should I count it off?
Crystal will count
1001,
it off.
1001.
All right, wait,
here's the
Mark,
deal.
Wait.
Okay, fuck.
All right, go ahead.
Jesus Christ. Here's the deal. We've made a transfer. Uh-huh. We've gone over into movie scoring.
Mm-hmm.
We decided that it would probably be a better idea since the world
isn't... I can't believe you guys did a podcast without me. That's so fucked up.
Exactly.
There will be a time for that. Not now.
I think it was pretty good, too.
It's number one. We have it up and it's downloaded. It's number one downloaded.
I'm sorry, Mark
was
saying something I wasn't listening.
All right, go ahead, Mark.
Mostly in France, though.
Ready and go.
Okay. So basically, the world is not ready for Orange Monkey, as far as I'm concerned. I think we're going to be really, really, really hot in like 2009.
It's true. We're totally ahead of our
time. But people just aren't ready for it. So we've decided to kind of move over into the movie scoring section, which I think
so
is
awesome.
This is definitely our calling, I believe. Mm-hmm. I think this song is pretty much going to
revolutionize
the film industry. Guys are going to revolutionize the film industry.
That's the plan.
Awesome. It's in the most amazing song. Ready and go. That made me love her all the more.
She's so funny.
So is Pape part of the band now? She's the lead singer now?
Oh, yeah. When she's old enough, I'm having her on stage with the tambourine.
Every time we go into the music room to jam or practice or whatever, she usually pushes her way in before me and runs to the drum set.
Yeah.
So.
She loves the drums. We did a show when she was like 2, and while we were setting up, she ran up and she sat on the drums. She had, Apple Martin... Gwyneth Paltrow's kid.
Uh-huh.
She had these little pink headphones that were like soundproofy headphones.
Uh-huh.
And she went to one of her dad's concerts and somebody took a picture and I was like, those are really cool. So I got Pape some. And they're like hot pink headphones, and you can like block the sound so she can come to our shows.
Oh, right on.
And she was up there with the little pink headphones on, and she had a white coat with little pink hearts on it, and she was jamming on the drums. It was That's really so cute. Everyone was so entertained.
She's so awesome. That is very cool.
Yeah.
So you guys are a multi-generational band.
You guys are.
Yeah.
Wow.
When
do
you have children?
When I find a woman who wants to have sex with me.
That was the perfect opportunity to ask her to have your kids. Seriously.
When, so like when do you want to have children?
There you go. Oh, my.
Wait, I think that Orange Monkey's amazing. What do you think of Orange Monkey, Lindsay?
I think they're amazing.
Amazing.
The towel and the head.
Amazing. I still can't look at you guys because I had that horrible day when I got thrown out of the band. It's horrible.
Yeah, what happened? How'd he get thrown out?
They said I was too fat. Peter said you're too fat.
You want to know the truth? You want to know the truth?
Yeah.
What? You want to tell it?
Yeah. There's too many racial slurs. We just couldn't handle it.
Really? Sorry, seriously? Man. Was there a meeting on this?
Yeah, we were like, he's out.
Really?
Well, it was between me and another crazy Dave that was in the band.
Wait a minute, really?
There's two Daves, and he just wasn't the better one.
Uh-oh, and two Daves is awkward. Wait a minute, but what
it's
about
not like my
slurs?
Two dads? Although that was a little awkward, too.
What was a little awkward?
Wait, I don't get, were they gay?
Yes, they were. They were boys.
No. Yes.
You're not gay if you just jerk someone
They both did the same girl.
It's not
girl.
Gay if you get another guy to suck your cock.
Yeah, I never understood that.
One of the dads was a total player, remember? He'd always like try and bring girls around.
Yeah,
and
one dad was
inappropriate.
Like, now, how were they two dads?
Yeah, I never
understood
that.
They both had sex with the same woman, and she never got a paternity test.
Did they refuse to do DNA testing or something?
They're like, even
at
if
at first
I'm not
they
your
were
father,
going
okay.
to.
Father.
Yeah, exactly.
Whoa. I can't believe members. Gotta hate
I can't
that
believe you remember what My Two Dads was about.
It was a good show.
The premise on My
Wait,
Two Dads.
Wait, hold on. How did you kick David out and why? I want to know for sure.
Smell.
He fucking quit.
Is it that?
Oh, he quit?
Can you put
I
it
didn't
down?
Quit.
Sorry.
We kicked you out.
I got kicked out for
I
want to
know
chubby.
If he quit or got kicked out. Which one?
No, you know.
It was a little bit of both.
He got quick.
I
out.
Think it was me.
Why
so,
did
I
you
said,
guys kick him out?
I said,
what was
get the
with
fuck
him?
Out of here, you son of a bitch. And he said, you
bitch.
Can't tell me that. I quit.
I quit.
And then you didn't have to pay him severance.
And then he kicked me in the nuts.
We were supposed to pay him.
I just want to know why you guys wanted to get rid of David.
No, I don't
and
think
And I
want to
avoid all of those things. All right,
should we tell the truth?
All right, here's the truth. The truth is that we try to move things around, but David just wants his own show. He didn't want to play our songs. He wanted his own songs, and then we moved everything. We even let him sing songs. We changed things.
We had our name.
Then he fucking quit.
Madonna, your head.
No, this is what it was.
Not your ass.
This is what it was. They're already the Beatles, and I was like Elvis. So it's like you can't have Elvis.
No, you're like
Yoko.
You're like Yoko. You're totally Yoko.
So we had our name printed on our drum and everything, and then he was like, I don't like that says Orange Monkey. I think it should say David.
But after I heard this song, I begged them to put me back in the band.
Who do you think you are?
But basically, I think to be an Orange Monkey, all you have to do is show up at rehearsals,
That's
right?
That's pretty much it.
I want
to
be in Forget It, I'm Leaving, Never Mind, I'm Leaving. That's
yeah, no
greatest.
Girls allowed in that,
no
sorry.
Girls. Yeah, they have, you guys have yeah. a new project.
There's
Never
no
mind,
girls
I'm
in emo.
By the way, thanks for bringing that up, Lindsay, prematurely.
Oh, premature ejaculation.
Well, I don't know. Not ejaculation.
No.
There's no
amazing.
Ejaculation yet. It's just
you guys
kind of,
deserve to
yes.
be
kind of just like giving myself a handy. Really, it's
you guys deserve amazing. To be multi-million-dollar rock stars because you guys are really amazing. Go to orangemonkey.net and check them out because they're just
dot
amazing.
.co.uk
buy everything and go to iTunes. You guys are on iTunes.
.ca.
.fr.
Are you guys on iTunes as well?
Yeah.
We're also on iTunes.
Oh, that's right. You have .ca. That's okay.
If they search for Orange Monkey, can they find you on iTunes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right
where
on.
Else are we on? We're on a bunch of other music sites.
They don't give us any money.
Okay, we're only on iTunes.
Yeah, we're only on iTunes.
iTunes. Is there anything
Does
else
iTunes
you guys
actually give you money?
We've
yeah.
paid like
yeah.
$80.
Yeah. yeah.
Really? How do they do it? Does they, it's like a PayPal thing?
No, they send checks.
They send a check.
They send us a check. $20 increments.
Oh, my God.
And Mark pockets those $20.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, I do.
Mark's made $80, apparently.
I owe Peter like $40 or $50.
Mark, you know, the big, really big thing business is a little slow.
Really big things.
Really
well,
big
apparently,
thing.
What? He's got some really big
thing just talking about the porn
in
industry.
Pants,
it's taking a lull right now.
Wait, Peter, actually, there's a rumor that Mark is the most well-endowed person that anybody knows. Is that true?
I heard that rumor.
In his pants?
It's not true, but he can suck his own cock.
Yeah!
I'm just saying.
Well, wait. then wouldn't it be true by that?
Yes, it is.
No, he just has a very short torso.
Yeah, there's no way I could.
There's no way that you could not be the most well-endowed person you know and be able to do that.
He's got no neck.
gross. Well, everybody picture it for a minute.
Let's not.
Okay. Wait. The well endowed part.
Move
or
along.
The
both.
No. Okay. I want to know about the sports report.
No. I want to know. I want to go around the table. What's your favorite? What's your favorite Orange Monkey song, Crystal?
Oh God.
Right now I'd have to say that I like there's kind of three. I like Demi Moore's Dead. Uh-huh. I like Maui, and I like
love Maui.
How does Maui
go? Actually, we're gonna have bars. You know what? Good. Can we use Maui?
Maui.
Listen, you can check out Maui on iTunes.com.
Can we use
purchase it?
Shut up.
Microsoft my money. It's a really big thing business.
Wait, can we put Maui on the end of this podcast for people to listen to part of it or no?
Just like, seriously, move your feet. They smell. I keep smelling this. It's foul smell.
Peter's feet. Peter's a hippie. Wait, can we put Maui, part of Maui, on the end of this podcast for people to listen?
Then we can. If it's not, awesome. Then we didn't. Oh.
I think we should only put peace so people can like
wait,
buy
so
the rest of
wait, oh. Jimmy Moore's Dead, Maui, and what other song is your favorite?
But.
And Peter, what's your favorite Orange Monkey song?
Burn.
Really?
Oh, that's a good one too.
Burn's a good one too. What about you over there?
There's a problem with this question.
Boring.
I think
he's gonna answer all his own songs, and he doesn't want it to sound conceited.
You know what?
He's the John Paul McCartney of the group, huh?
Here's
he's
the thing. Won't Here's work the thing. The there, there's okay, really only about three
he's
or four
really
songs.
The talent kind of thing?
There's only about three or four songs I have not been involved in.
And those
in
are
a major part.
Hate.
And those are your favorite songs?
And those are I like all of them. I know this sounds really stupid and fucking cliche, but I have like an attachment, like a mental like
you
spiritual attachment
song,
to like
so
every
brilliant.
Single one of them. And I like them all.
God, throw them out of the studio.
I'm just saying. I'm not trying to be an arrogant dick. I'm just saying that I enjoy listening to.
Wait, really fast. I want to know what songs you weren't involved with.
Maybe she has children. There was
a lot of really old ones. A lot of the really old stuff. Like there was like Wizards and Pokemon.
No idea what
from
that
like.
Even I'm a diehard Orange Monkey fan, but I have no idea.
That song, by the way, and used it.
Yeah, I've heard about that. Peter
shit.
Like showed me something, and he's like,
"So
yeah.
Is that UJ Tech? Is that also called UJ
no,
Tech?"
No, dude.
What is it? How does it go?
And then there's like
that,
sound
let's
effects.
Go.
Yes,
that's called TJ Tech on one of them. I love that
negative.
One.
What did you use that
What's
for?
What's TJ Tech then?
That's
yeah,
the one that sounds like mariachi.
I just stole it. It's like, you know, like you steal the Doors or
what
the
did
Beatles,
you steal it
the same
for?
Thing. For what was it for? It was for
some dumb fucking thing you did.
Ads or something like that.
Let's move on.
Yeah,
all right,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
all right, whatever.
So wait, no, wait. Everybody shut up for a second when nobody say anything.
You just
we're going to listen to an Orange Monkey song right now.
No.
Wait.
No. At the
okay, wait, I'm going to say it again. We're going to listen to an Orange Monkey song right
time,
now, and then we're going to discuss it after right now.
No.
Okay, now we're back, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, that's a great song.
Wow, fantastic.
That David was my favorite song.
Now do you see why they're so amazing, Lindsay?
I've always thought they're
easy to play live.
All right, Orange Monkey, get out of the studio. All right, Mark. We got Gark Marvin with Sports Report.
Gark Marvin.
Wow.
What up, guys?
I would like to say that UCLA won the Super Bowl, and I'm really pleased.
You know what?
They're going to the World Series.
Guys. I don't give
get
a
the
fuck.
Stanley Cup.
They're not Canadian. Ow!
UCLA won, right?
Yeah.
13-7, was it?
I thought it was 13-9.
I don't know.
Wait, it must be 13-7. He is the sports reporter. I think he was.
No,
right.
No.
Oh, I think a nail file. Score at one point in the game. But didn't move forward.
I would not contest Gark Marvin, the sports reporter.
Gark Marvin thought that Brett Favre played for the Rangers.
Well, you know what? He might be changing. You know, a lot of superstars
like
change
Jordan.
Sports.
Yeah,
Michael sports. Jordan changed sure. sports. I wouldn't put... He's the
yeah,
expert.
UCLA, didn't Bo know everything?
UCLA
too?
Kicked...
Huh?
Didn't Bo know everything?
Yeah, Bo knew everything.
USC's ass. We didn't really kick their ass, but we
put... All right, could you let him go on?
Sad,
you know what?
It's
oh, my God.
Do
you guys
report?
Remember that time Lindsay wouldn't shut the hell up? And I
no,
tell
I don't.
My fucking
I don't.
Sports
I don't.
Report.
I don't.
All right, Lindsay, can you shut up? Let's try it. Let's actually...
I got a lot of time to make up because you guys are sucking.
Crystal, in your mind, count off 5 minutes and let us know when it's over. And let's see if Lindsay...
Can I use my watch instead?
5 minutes. I'd like to see you shut up for 5 minutes, Fatso.
I can do
and
it.
And both
of you go. Wait, vagina. Vagina.
Both of you go.
Ready and go.
Weird, you just stuck your finger in her vagina.
This is going to make for a really bad podcast
so
if no one's talking for 5 minutes.
Here's the deal, guys. Check it out. So, this week, the LA Kings kicked the shit out of the Anaheim Ducks. They won 3-2. Now, with about a minute and 16 seconds left, they got their third goal, and they needed it really, actually, because... but in about 38 seconds, the Todd Marchant, I believe, scored another goal for the Ducks.
Oh, it's in 38 seconds.
Oh, she talked before I did.
He said it's 38 seconds.
What? No, what? It's, no, we're supposed to go for 5 minutes.
You guys lasted 30 seconds.
Not me, her.
30. Oh, yeah, you're not talking right now.
Shh, all right.
I put the podcast before your stupid little vendettas over there. Oh. Chubby.
Okay.
Tick a lock. Right, go ahead, Garth.
Okay,
Marvin.
Also, the New York Islanders beat the New York Rangers 7-4. Fucking awesome. Victor Kozlov got there, got him up into first place with his first four-goal game in the NHL, in his NHL
he
career.
He made four goals. He himself.
He himself made
Victor
four
Kozlov?
Goals.
Victor Kozlov?
First full goal.
Hit that. We'd all like to, yeah.
So now his scoring actually set off Brendan Shannon's 18th hat trick. Islanders.
Is this the Magic Castle?
Were you just transcribing stuff from ESPN, but you sort of flip channels in the middle of the.
So, anyway.
What are you talking about?
Wait, and then on Gilmore Girls.
For our people that don't know, what is exactly hat trick in hockey?
If you don't know, then I don't care.
Then you don't care.
Canadian.
No,
wait,
no,
wait.
Let's
ask Cristal. She's Canadian.
I think David knows. Okay. That's why he's being such a.
So. It's when you have a hat, right? And then there's a bunny inside, and you pull the bunny.
I have hats in hockey.
No, I think it's isn't it just when you pull something out of your ass, like or something? I don't know.
No, there's an actual hat trick.
I don't know. Oh, Peter knows what it is.
Peter, what
Peter
is it,
who
Peter?
Just
when
said
you
that
do three goals in one game.
Isn't that what it is?
I don't think so.
You just sounded really definitive about. I know what it is.
That's where you
now
score.
You're asking.
Are you sure?
I play a lot of video game hockey. They throw a whole bunch of hats. Three game. I think it's actually.
Is it three in a row?
I can't even look at you, producer Peter. I thought you were on my side.
Okay. One more
thing.
Which side
is that?
Wait, what are you talking about? What? Oh, you're still upset about us doing a podcast without you? Sans Lindsay.
Still.
You know what? I even had to. Ladies and gentlemen, we had another big fight right before this podcast because I was like, let's go do a podcast. She's like, I don't know if I want to do podcast anymore. And I'm like, why?
What
the fuck? She's like, because people don't like them.
Nobody has ever told me anything about the podcast.
And I had to tell her what all the people. That comment
a lot of people that were like, oh, I want to fuck Lindsay so hard.
Bro, that's scary.
She's
my
done anal in the last 2 years. She's so fucking hot.
Yeah. Edit this out.
Ladies and gentlemen, can you please go on our MySpace page and leave us comments telling us what you think, or you can even email us at podcast@davidmonster.com. podcast@davidmonster.com or go on our podcast LCD podcast page on MySpace, because Lindsay is very temperamental and she needs to hear a positive response.
Mental.
I know. Let's give a shout out. Let's give a shout out
Mark,
to LaVon. Isn't he our biggest fan?
Long enough, and you can tell me how you feel.
Yeah, really wait. You know LaVon, Mark. What do you think of LaVon, our biggest fan ever? Hey, stupid, Gark Marvin.
What?
LaVon.
I'm confessing my love
fan?
To Lindsay in
oh.
silence.
She's jerking him off on the table.
My
no, that
right
was
here.
Just me.
No, they weren't. No, they weren't.
Jerking myself off,
we didn't
guys.
See them for a good
you guys are filthy.
7 minutes. I was
clean.
Telling you.
Wait, I want to give shout-outs to all our fans, because maybe people that are our fans will tell us that they're our fans. Oh, Ethan. Ethan from Sacramento.
Yo, Ethan.
Left me a thing saying that it's the funniest thing he's ever heard of in his whole life.
Sweet.
What? Actually, what? No, it's really cool. Actually, I don't want to mention his name because it'll set somebody off in the room, but somebody else really likes our podcast a lot, and that's why he wants to be on it really bad.
Is it Christian? So
his stupid. Name is just like Carl, but with a T.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, he's going to...
He's
gonna...
really cool.
Let's change the subject, guys.
Uh-oh. Okay, continue on with your sports report, Gark Marvin.
So there's only one more thing I have here. Just Ryan Smith of the Edmonton Oilers is actually out, unfortunately, with a broken right thumb.
Who cares?
No, I think this is interesting. I didn't know Ryan Seacrest played hockey.
No, Smith.
Oh, whatever.
Just lost. Anyway, he hurt his thumb during the first period of a game to
Columbus,
which they lost
too.
4-0.
I have those mitts, you know, those shower mitts that you use to scrub yourself?
They're like loofah mitts?
Loofah mitts, yeah, but they don't have a thumb.
And you have a bad shower mitt.
And I was doing something, and it was very painful.
Why don't you put your thumb on the outside of the mitt?
Because then I wouldn't be able to get the whole hand.
Wait, Lindsay, one time, she has a nickname called the Mighty Whitey or One-Eyed Williams. Because she showed up at school with an eye patch on. And her friend Ryan told me that they were like, oh wow, they weren't making fun of her, and they're like, wow, that's really horrible. Yeah, they're like, how did it happen? And she's like, I was in the shower and I got apricot scrub in my eye.
Hey, I'm serious, I scratched my cornea.
So maybe then they made fun of her and called her One Eyed Williams the Mighty Whitey.
Maybe you should take baths. That's your problem. Seriously. You need to be sitting down for these activities.
That's true. I really think I sprained my thumb. She's because the thing is, it's so difficult to
it's not.
Oh, and the other thing is, they're like flippers, and I had to empty the scrub into my hand.
Oh, my God.
And it slipped and hit me in the knee.
Wait, why are you using a scrub and loofah? You're just trying to get your
it's not the scrub.
You're going to be like gosh, red
the backwash.
Bleeding.
She's too dumb to take a shower.
But, and the opposable grip really helps. You guys
sorry,
are like a bunch of trained seals.
Tell us more about your shower experiences. What were you wearing in the shower?
But you have the flippers.
Hopefully nothing, otherwise she's a weird.
Wait,
I was
it's hotter when a girl says it.
She was wearing flippers.
Loofah mittens.
Tell us about like scrubbing over your body, what you saw.
Shut
what did you
up.
See when
okay,
you're scrubbing
is that
your
all
body?
For the sports report?
Oh, wait. Yeah, I think so, right?
Yes, that was all for my... That was the end of my
Ryan
all hockey sports report. Since no one got that.
I didn't know that was all hockey. I didn't even think about that because I didn't
Oh,
listen.
That's hot. Are you? Is this a Canadian ploy or anything?
No.
This is
it's
insidious.
It's supposed to be funny.
Yes. Insidious, Crystal. You're taking
but
over.
But no one's getting it.
Crystal
so fuck
checks us
you
at
guys.
Every turn.
You know what? Maybe you need to be a little less obvious.
Okay, how about this?
I mean,
this?
More obvious.
How about this? Every single sports report I've ever done for you guys, I have claimed that hockey is not happening this year. And now I've just gone and... Oh,
that is good!
Sports report, and you know what? Didn't fucking get it!
Mark, you shouldn't
Fuck!
Do that! Because
Mark,
no,
we're
experience.
Not!
I had to explain would be like,
the joke! Wait,
like,
Mark, you tricked us. You should be happy you actually tricked
yeah.
us. We, you
yeah,
you
guys, you're
tricked.
Suckers!
Sucker! Clevier! Wait.
What?
Wait, since
what?
We lost... Shut up. Clevier? Shut up. Since we lost our sorority reporter, can you do a sorority report?
We lost no. her? Did she die?
Yeah, she left, didn't she? Is she out?
Oh, you mean like she went downstairs? Is that
Oh, she's downstairs? She's still here?
Yeah.
Oh, good. We can have her for the sorority part. But what about your sorority experiences, Mark? What happened in the sorority when you were sharing? Yeah, what about
that?
You're running around in your bra and panties.
Lots of pillow fights, loofah scrumming.
So, I don't think that's a good idea.
Why? Why is that?
I have nothing.
I want to know your first lesbian experience. Oh, so wait, I've been really, really, really hyping this, and people are really interested in this. It's a trip through Lindsay's mind. Oh, okay, God. Today, Lindsay almost ate
yeah.
Lindsay almost ate a fly today.
I thought she did eat a fly. She's saying
no,
it's
she
better
didn't.
Than sucking. Okay.
Tell us a little bit about that fly eating experience.
Well, I remember that I speared a, there's something you guys don't know about me, but I am a huge fan of Hearts of Palm. And I speared of Hearts and Palm, and there was a little black thing on it, and I didn't notice it. Well, I noticed it, but I was
eating.
Like, whatever. And then later, I looked down at my fork, and there was a fly stuck between the
was
palms.
Was this at a
it
restaurant?
Dead.
No, it was
no,
in
I went
house.
To the Whole Foods buffet, and it was in my car at the Observe. And I almost threw up, but you know, I kept on, and I had a meatball sandwich to
you
wash it down.
But she ate an entire salad with a fly in her fork. And the thing is, you don't know about Lindsay. She's been stressed out about it ever since. She's been
you
thinking
know,
about
if I drank
the...
urine, I would have to kill myself.
Maybe
but
you should drink
is...
the urine to kill the bacteria at the fly. Oh, just put in.
But the trip, this is the trip through Lindsay's mind. Lindsay's sitting there thinking like she's shaking and she's thinking like she's retaking the journey of the fly. Like, oh my God, what did it land on? It landed on poop. Then it went in and landed
oh,
on the, it landed on radioactive materials and outside my body.
That's not the thing about flies. The thing about flies is every time they land, they throw up.
No, I know. And she's
so
thinking about
that
too.
To,
see, that's going on yeah. through her mind too.
I think I might throw up.
Cause see, Lindsay, this is what
time
Lindsay
you land.
Did. This is Lindsay. We were at the observatory eating. She was eating a meatball sandwich, and she was done. She threw it down. She's like, "Let's go." So I was like, "Okay." I took my fork, and there was a meatball left, and I stuck it.
He stuck his fork
it.
And my meatball.
So she flipped out. She's like, "Ow!" I can't eat that now. And it's like, wait, I pulled my fork.
You didn't even ask,
head.
Though. That's the
no, but that's
principle.
The thing. That's Lindsay. She's so flipped out. But I mean, she's had my penis in
friends?
Her mouth, and she
Hell
can't
no,
even.
No, we're not oh. such good friends that he yeah. shouldn't have to ask.
No, but see, the thing is uh-huh. what's good for the goose is not good for the gander because she'll.
I spears
when
meatballs
my food
on
arrives. Yeah, actually, I got a shake today at Coffee Bean. She grabbed it and drank out of it before I could even.
Because she wanted
it.
She wanted to drink it before you got
yeah.
your germs on
yeah.
it.
Yeah,
but she doesn't care if you get hurt.
No, I know, but if
I'm
Mark
not germy
took
like
a
you
fork
are.
And just put it touched your food and you're like, oh no, and then he's like, forget it.
Whatever, Mark will chew my gum. Yeah, I totally eat that.
David chews my gum too.
She tricked me into it. She spit out her gum on a plate and it looked the same color as this.
Did she say, here, it's fresh gum?
No. She said, you chewed it? No, she's a stupid bitch, and she spit it out on this pie that we were going to share, and it was the same color as, like, the decorations on the pie.
You're so hungry.
And then the pie fell over onto it, so I took a scoop of a pie.
He's chewing my gum!
And then I ate the pie, and I was like, this is weird. What is this decoration? Is it plastic? Because you know when gum hardens when yeah. it's cold and stuff? And I was like, that's weird. I'm chewing. That's good. And then I calmly took it out and put it in a napkin. And
hey,
I was like,
didn't you? What the fuck is
yeah,
this?
But I mean, well, relatively.
I would have jumped out of the window.
There was a pane glass window right there. And if Lindsay would have done that, she would have jumped out of the window, shattering the window, screaming. But I was pretty calm comparatively, you have to admit.
Yeah, I would have had it in my life.
But see, the thing is...
your ABC gum. Oh, God, it makes me sick to think about it.
ABC gum. What year were you born?
1985.
See, we're convinced what? That she was probably Howard Hughes because she's so insane about germs. But this is what she thinks. Nobody can touch her food or even... If I touched the plate one time and moved her plate... Touch the plate. Didn't touch
it's
any food.
You're grody.
And she would not eat. She's like, disgusting. I will not eat anything on that plate. I just touched the edge of the plate to move it over
yeah,
once.
Yeah, it's weird.
She out.
Nobody disagrees with you, David.
No. But this is, it gets weirder. But people can drink out of her alcohol, like if she has a Cosmopolitan.
Well, it's self-cleaning.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I think that
it's like an autoclave.
This is crazy. I think just
look,
just
I
crazy.
Am only grossed out by you because you're gross.
Yeah, I picked up and I had a sandwich and I ate the meat out of it and then there was a piece of it with mayonnaise and I just took a bite of it and she's like, oh my God, that's so disgusting. You're eating
it was mayo bread. It was
yeah, it's
bread
like I just took
mayo.
A little tiny bite and
yeah,
that grosses her out.
Well, it's...
Oh, God.
All right, we had coffee once and it was my coffee and I dunked a cookie in it and took a bite of the cookie. She's like, oh my God, I'm going to throw up. Oh my God,
that's
because
it looks like he's giving... I don't want to say, but it's all so sensual whenever you're eating, and it kind of
it's all I got. Food is all I have.
You're not making love to it.
Let him have his
food. Yeah, you know well, what? Though. If I could make love to a person, I would, but I can't, so I make love to food. What's Aww. Wrong with that?
Why can't you make love to a person?
Because yeah, I'm like you, Mark. No one will let me.
No one will let him stick. Oh, Mark, that's so sad.
That's, I know.
That's
why
a little
don't
sad
you
for
get
both
together?
Of us. Right?
I know.
I'm not sure whether to feel offended or sorry.
But, I'm like you.
But on the last podcast, Mark said if I supported him, he would marry me tomorrow. He said he's already in the car on the way to the Justice
And you guys
of Peace.
Could totally adopt. Kids.
No,
so
we don't need
cute.
To adopt.
No, let's adopt. We can get like $750 a kid, dude.
No, that's not adopting. That's
foster care.
Yeah, let's foster care. Let's get like seven or eight kids.
Wait a minute. But don't they cost that much to support?
Nah, just throw them in a shed and give them oats.
Oh my God.
Oats. Oh my God.
And honey.
Huh? Oh, we're done?
We're like
93
minutes.
Yeah, but the first,
oh,
half, the first half was crap. Let's be honest, people.
Oh, my God. Crystal, Jewel of the North. I can't believe these things you're saying.
Jewel of the North.
I funny. Wanted to support her,
like
but I guess
feet
not.
In here.
All right, let's end off this time by going around and all saying
buddy!
Things we're thankful for.
Oh, I did that at my Thanksgiving.
All right, let's do, instead of that, Sweet. Let's all go and everybody has to say something they like best about me. What do they like best about me? Crystal, you start.
I like your coordination, your fashion coordination.
Really?
Yeah.
Describe everybody what I'm wearing today.
What are you playing with your
David's
pants
wearing,
for?
Well, let's see, a green shirt because he always matches his boxers with his clothes. Do you not notice this?
Yeah, but so he's got to pull them up.
Okay,
otherwise,
so he's wearing green boxers that have a little girl dressed as a cowgirl riding a little stick horse.
Is that
And
hot?
Then a green shirt buttoned down, no sleeves, and a black shirt underneath it. And black
and
shoes
I can't believe
with
you're
green
putting your
on
fingers
them,
on the
with
bottom
a little
of
green
shoes.
Skull and crossbone. They're
you're
pretty
such
new.
A,
they like.
A germaphobe.
I think these are new shoes, aren't they?
Yeah,
these are like
that's like
putting your hand on the ground. I actually wondered how many pairs of shoes you own because they look so new.
That's nothing.
And then he's got brown pants on.
57 pairs of shoes.
And black socks with skull and crossbones to match the shoes that have the skull.
Only 57.
Yeah, I got rid of a whole bunch because they're old and stuff. That. I gotta get
okay,
more.
Okay, Peter's
shoes.
Peter's next.
Peter, what's your favorite thing about me? What do you love most about me?
I like that you're obnoxious.
God, you can say that again.
I think that you like that you could tap into my evil. Because Peter is evil, and he could tap into it, and he can get me going like the podcast without...
No, but I don't like the fact that you make up with Lindsay when I say don't take her phone calls. That's what I don't
he
like.
He was calling me, Producer Peter.
I know.
He was calling me.
I did not.
He's a total liar. Of course
he was calling me. I didn't call him once.
I apologized.
Like, come on over right now, and then blah, blah, blah. Anyways. But, I like that you're kind of evil. You're like that guy, Dr. Evil.
I'm your pawn. You could...
You're saying that because he's bald.
Yeah, maybe I am. You're like a tan Dr. Evil.
I'm ugly.
Don't forget Chubby.
Oh, my God.
Wait, are we going
to
show the word Chubby around?
She better have really nice to say.
You know what? Screw you. You're gonna get it from me, but good, buddy.
Whoa, dude.
Really? It's
hot.
On to you right now.
Now you don't have to rely on food anymore.
You're going to get it. I'm going to get it from you hot.
You're one step ahead of me, dude.
All right, go ahead. What do you love most about me? What's your favorite thing about me?
I think despite all the shit that people have talked about me to you over the years, you've backed me up and been a good friend.
He likes the way you make him feel.
The only one person ever talks shit about you to me.
Who?
We can't.
But you told him to go to hell.
Yeah, I was like, I don't think
so.
You're
like, I don't think so. And I think that's an admirable quality.
It was so funny.
Most people just listen and go, oh.
We're not going to say who it was. I'll tell you later. But the funny thing was is she thought she was a better friend than you. And she goes, she said it all. And I go, no, I don't think so. She goes, what? Like, she was so shocked, and I was like, yeah, I don't believe it, sorry. And she's like, but, she was, like, totally like that for, like,
I remember this.
Yeah, I'll tell you about it later. She's like, I need to call you right now, because we were online, and then she's like, I can't believe
you're
saying
this. Happened. Yeah,
I think aside from that, just not even that one incident, you've just been a good friend.
Oh, thank
you,
Mark. I think you guys
have
been amazing
friends,
too.
Thank you for being a friend.
I'm going to go throw up now, and I can't think of a single thing I like about you, because my heart is so full of hatred for you.
Are you still heartbroken that we did a podcast?
Heartbroken? I hate you.
We had to do it. It's something we had to do.
You know what else I like about you?
What?
That she hates you for us all doing a podcast without her.
Yeah, you're taking the heat.
Yeah, thanks for that, bro.
I expected it from you too, and she's Canadian. I didn't expect it from producer Peter.
Peter? You didn't expect it from Peter? Wouldn't you
Peter's
guys say
so nice to me.
You are the two people who know Peter best in the whole world? Wouldn't you expect him to mastermind something like that? Isn't that? Oh yeah, of course Peter does.
I love Peter dearly, but he's a total jerk.
No, he's not jerk as much as he's evil.
Then
he's just conniving.
He's starting to find out.
Yeah, he's conniving. He's an evil genius is what he is.
Doesn't that make someone a jerk?
Not necessarily. I think it's endearing.
Why are you petting me while you say that?
It's one of my favorite
qualities.
You know what it is? You know what Peter is? He's so clever. It goes to the evil because
he's an evil genius.
So beyond it's so clever. His head is full. So he's you know what I mean?
His head is full.
No,
that's
I'm
what
saying
Mark's mom says about Peter.
That he's egotistical?
Yeah.
No. Conceited.
No,
conceited.
He's not conceited. He's just so clever that it has to go somewhere, and sometimes it goes to evil.
Really not? Yeah.
There's
not,
so
not
much
conceited?
There.
I
Are you conceited, Peter?
Yes.
All right, come on.
My general point is you can't
fuck right off.
None of us are going anywhere until you say what you love best about me.
I'll be fine sitting here. I took a nap in my car today. I'm all refreshed.
We have a spare mattress in Patreon if you want.
Come on. All right, beyond that. You
go to hell, Chubby.
Listen, we had to do it to continue. This is our new drama line. We're not mentioning the other drama line ever again.
You
this
can
is our
rot
new drama line.
In hell. You just licked the microphone.
You're disgusting.
You
make
me sick.
You don't even understand. She's going to be worried about this for like a month now.
We had a reggae band in here earlier. I can't believe you just did that.
They were sweating all over the microphones.
And one of them had pus. She's frantically drinking water right now.
Remember that thing about having acne all over your face until you're like 90? That was the guy who was using that mic.
I can still feel it on my tongue. It's all like,
you don't even understand. Waffling. She's gonna take a shower and scrub herself like in.
She's gonna take that loofah.
What's that Meryl Streep movie?
She's gonna take a rape shower.
Yeah, what's that Meryl Streep movie?
Rape shower. I'm gonna have to gargle with
she's
acid.
Take a Silkwood shower like they did the radiation. And then she's gonna wake up in the middle of the night, and go ah. And she's gonna take another shower. You don't even know, Lindsay. She's insane.
I need some alcohol to kill the pain.
All right, so what do you like best about me? Say
nothing.
Something nice
you
about
can
me.
Fuck off, asshole.
Come on.
No.
You were supposed to be a good friend, and through all of this, you're supposed to see something anyway.
You are a baby. You're whiny. You're bitchy. You're selfish.
Selfish?
Selfish?
Yeah. Who's selfish?
Look who's selfish.
Selfish? I've given Lindsay 5 of the greatest birthdays of her life where she's like, this
I
is
don't
the
care.
Greatest
you
day
suck.
Of my life. On my last birthday, she calls me up. She's like, where do you want to go for your birthday? And I said a place, and she's like, oh, God. She says that, and then she calls me back like an hour later. She's like, we can't go there. The lady's giving me problems. What other place do you want
to
go? Think of another place.
Well, how come
you guys didn't so it's like, wait a minute. Yeah, she didn't even invite you guys
yeah,
to
did.
It.
Yeah, I did actually invite you guys. I talked to you, and I never mind. It's just lame.
I think
nope.
I was drunk.
No, but I'm just proving that you're the
yeah,
selfisher.
You are.
I was. I think I was drunk. Sorry.
Hey, drunkie.
I'm just trying to prove that you're the selfisher of the two of us.
You can rot in hell, and you were a big baby about that party. Just want you to know. And I never apologized.
Can't you let this go?
I never apologized.
Yeah, you begged my forgiveness.
Oh, I fucking didn't.
Wait till you hear the reenactment. It tells the true story.
Alright, later.
You know what? We're not going anywhere until you say something good.
What are you going to do? Force me?
Yeah, I'm going to touch your vagina if you don't say something good.
Ah, gross! Get away from me.
Alright, we're wrapping up. Lindsay's that petty.
Last night, at the strip joint, while I was lying around, some guy shoving dollar bills in my pants, and all I could think about was Maui, bright sunsets, women in grass skirts, everyone's getting laid. You know, I'd like to go to Maui someday. But I'd like to go without the guys who are shoving their hands down my pants. Ooh, Maui. Behind the counter at Dunkin' Donuts, I said to myself, maybe someday I could go to Maui. I could wear a bowl of fruit on my head. Or is that Venezuela? No matter, I could do it anyway. It's Maui. And anything comes true in Maui. All your dreams, there in Maui, laying in the sand. Thank you. lobster in Maui? And I mean, if they do they catch it right off the coast? Or is it imported from Alaska or something? And if it is imported from Alaska, is it frozen or is it fresh? Either way, I'd still eat those Krabby Claws.